You're lying to me.
Virus to bring dire straits to your environment.
Money for nothing and seeds for free. We're going to play a little Binding of Isaac Antwerp Plus, and then in our middle section, we're going to play Ultimate Chicken Horse. And then finally, we're going to play some Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed. Why don't we get started with a little bit of a seed?
You're going to love this seed.
Oh, I guess
Who
might
it be?
Josh is giving the seed
today. It's an Isaac
seed. Yeah.
Okay.
It is 0WL3.
I like owl. Owl.
Yeah, exactly.
Owl 3. Yeah, okay.
Owl 3. 1HA9.
Chad, don't look at my streak.
All right, I hope it gives me the owl power up first thing.
Wait, you said it was an Isaac seed, right?
Yes.
Okay. Hell yeah.
Yeah, I did not start with the Isaac owl power up, so the seed sucks.
I'm just trying to make sure. Wait, do I have mods on? I probably don't have mods on.
Do you have a no achievements?
Yeah, but that's because it's a seed.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see, you know.
That's one way to figure it out.
I've been down those lonesome roads I've ever known.
So you've played this game before?
A little bit, like, you know, every day for the past 5 years, basically.
Why?
I don't know. I mean, at this point, it's almost like I've made a bet with some kind of, like a demon who's kind of an asshole.
You know what I mean? Like, you sold yourself out to, like, Satan. Just to play Isaac.
It was mostly worth it. Like, the game tends to be pretty good. There's sometimes when I'm like, eh, not really. But, like, it's usually pretty good. It varies. Can I ask you a question? Can I ask you a question I've never asked anybody before in my life, Josh?
Yeah?
How was your weekend?
It was a good weekend. I got drunk and played chess at a bar.
Yeah, I saw that. I said my move is one pawn to e4, and you said 6t to t9.
Yeah.
See, that the move doesn't make any sense, though.
It makes sense if you are a grandmaster at chess.
Oh, really? Is that the... I guess I'll have to talk to freaking Yasser Sirwan and see about that.
Yeah, exactly. So that was a lot of fun. I liked that day. And then, like, we just, like, continued to get drunk at, like, other bars, and then we came back to my place, and we watched...
Nice, dude.
We watched Men in Black.
Checked out your etchings, if you know what I mean.
Then we watched Wild Wild West.
Right, yeah.
And then we watched Independence Day.
Oh, that's like a Will Smith triple feature. That's
it
pretty great.
Is he really in all of those?
Huh? No, he's only in the first two.
Because I remember him in Wild Wild West. He plays Jim West.
Desperado.
Yes. I mean, we've all seen it many times, hopefully. It was on the syllabus for this weekend, so. Men in Black.
Yes. He's the black one.
Oh!
That's what, yeah. Like, the Men in Black. It just meant, like, the white
it's
man.
It's easy to forget
in the
that
black.
Will Smith is in Men in Black.
Right, yeah.
He plays such a minor role.
I think that's how I got confused. But in Independence Day.
Minority role.
Bill... That's Tom Cruise. Bill Pullman, R.I.P. Randy Quaid, Jeff Goldblum. Can we talk about that?
What do you want? I don't know. What do you want to talk about? I wasn't done talking about my weekend. You hide.
Well,
it.
I mean, why is his name Jeff Goldblum? Because it's not.
Yeah, he should be. Yeah, he's not blooming. He thinks he's an onion.
Yeah, his name's Jeff Goldblum.
Goldblum and onion.
He thinks he's an onion.
Or yeah, a flower or something.
Really Blum and Onion. You never heard of that?
Yeah, I've heard of it.
It doesn't sound like it.
I just
you
don't think that
me.
Jeff Goldblum wants to be an onion.
Well, why does he make his name like that then?
You're saying Jeff Goldblum has layers? Because that sounds like...
I mean, you're already calling him the name that I want you to call him. So as far as I'm concerned, we're cool.
All right. Yeah, good chat.
It'd be like if you were like, hey, my name's Josh Smuth.
So that's what you're going to give me? You're going to give me Josh
Smuth?
Well, it's pronounced differently than it says, isn't it?
That's what you think.
And I'm Nick Ornstein.
Yeah, exactly. Look, my name's spelled Ryan, but it's pronounced Rionda. Like, the English language has rules, man. You can't just circumvent them.
You know what's hilarious is that I didn't even go live. And I've been playing, like, super hot this entire fucking time. That's hilarious.
You've been playing like
you
that
playing
means
super hot.
Well, it means he's been playing like really well at Isaac.
Yeah, I've been playing really well at Isaac.
like his run is super hot right now.
Yeah, it's
time to slow down when you
hot run. Yeah, so it's just time for me to slow down. Yeah,
time for you to slow down. It's time to stop.
Usually, yeah, I've thought that a few times, like in my life. Like whenever I come across a traffic light and it's red, I'm like, time to stop.
Yeah.
When do you start going again, though? Because that's the part nobody can ever figure it out.
You know what? I'm glad you asked, Nick, because this brings me to my Northern Lion bone of the week. I got a bone to pick with you motherfuckers. I see you
as well.
Excuse me. I see you at the traffic lights, shaking that ass. And I see you. You stop on a red. Good for you. Here's your cookie. Then you see that it turns red for the other direction. You know, the people going, trying to get to work the way they want to. They got to go to make money in today's world. And then you start to inch forward on the starting line. You inch forward on the starting line. What are you trying to do? You think you're Mario Andretti? You're going to beat the light? And then inevitably, the other side gets a protected left. You're already like 20% out in the intersection. And you got to like throw it in reverse to make the rest of us look like assholes. That's my bone of the week. Stop trying to beat the traffic light. Just go when it turns green, you moron.
Yeah.
But I never trusted that concept that they tell you when you're turning left. You should go most of the way into the lane before you turn.
No, wait, what?
You gotta do that, though.
Wait, say that one more time.
When you're turning left, you go most of the way into the turn before you're allowed to go.
Well, you go out into the intersection, but straight.
You go out into the intersection, which is stupid. That's actually stupid.
Wait, you're telling me that when you're driving and you want to make a left-hand turn at a light, you have to just, like, go when it's red?
Get ready when it turns green to turn, and you pull all the way into the intersection pretty much, and then as soon as there's a gap in traffic, you actually make the turn.
Yeah.
Reasoning for why that's stupid is because if you have to wait through the whole light, you're now in the middle of everybody.
And that's that's driving in Vancouver. Like, if you're turning left, you wedge yourself out into the intersection to basically just be like, I'm waiting until everybody else stops running their red, and then I'm going to make the turn. So you can choose to kill me if you want, but I'm going. So if you want to be a murderer, then by all means. But I'm fitting in on this fucking
light.
That's
how I was taught, and I didn't agree with it when I was taught.
Do you do it, though?
I thought I knew better, actually, back then.
Because when you go out into the intersection, it means that at least one person's getting through on that one. Do they not do this in Pennsylvania? Josh has given us nothing on this one.
So in Pittsburgh, there's a thing called a Pittsburgh left. So it's what you're describing. So you're at it.
Yeah, it's what the industry did when the manufacturing sector collapsed in the year 2008. Hey-ho.
I'm mad that you just said that line of words. But anyways, so a Pittsburgh left is when you're at an intersection and the people and you're just waiting for the light to go green. And you know that the light is going to go green for you, but it's also going to go green for the guys that are, coming towards you.
Right, yeah. Absolutely.
So, what you do is you just fucking gun it to the left, ASAP. But, everyone in Pittsburgh knows, that asshole's going to do it across the way, so they just let it happen.
Acceptable, yeah.
So, we don't necessarily, and I guess you could, scoot your bum in front of your car out into, the front in, the middle of the lane, and we sometimes see that, but I mean, I think you'll find that everywhere. I don't think that's a Vancouver thing, or I don't think it's
no, I'm just saying traffic is
traffic sucks.
It's not great here. It's not as bad as it is in Seattle or downtown Manhattan, but it's
Manhattan.
You just wait, dude. You just fucking wait until we get Roberto on the show. He starts talking this bullshit about Manhattan, but yeah, you basically do that's. I grew up driving in the country, and, you cross somebody on the country road, you give them a little wave,
You say, give them, the middle finger.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's the big city wave. This guy's also driving a car. Fuck you. You can ask Kate. There's multiple times, probably weekly, where I'm like, all right, dude, I'm going to change lanes. So it's really up to you if you want to, risk one of us dying. I have to get to where I need to go. I've waited as long as I conceivably can. So it's up to you to either, how much does this spot mean to you? Does it mean that we're both going to go to court in like 6 months to get this resolved? Or are we just going to do it right now and like get on with our lives?
The ultimate in apathy. You're like, you know what? If we both die, you know, I guess that's just the way the cards fell.
Like, I've been waiting for a spot to open up in this fucking lane for 10 minutes and everybody's just, you know, speeding up to cut it off from you. So tell you what, you want the spot, you're going to have to kill a man. Decide if that's worth it for you.
And
yeah,
it always
I mean,
is.
Might as well, right?
I mean, they had the right
What
way.
Else do you have to live for if you don't have the spot?
That's little known. It's called the Grandfather Clause of 1941. If you have the right of way and you kill someone in your car, get off scot-free. Hell, they name a street after you.
Who's grandfather?
Is it your clause? Because that sounds like your basis for annihilating all jaywalkers.
Well, see, this is... a lot of Northern Lionisms have been taken out of context. People seem to think I want jaywalkers to die. That's not the case. I just think that if they cause the accident with a self-driving car, they should die. Instead of the person in the self-driving
car. The jaywalker causes the accident with a self-driving car.
Hear me out, Josh. I don't know if you were on the show when we talked about it. You're in a self-driving car. You're in the passenger seat reading. Right now. You're in the back seat of your self-driving car reading the newspaper, probably the stock section, because you sound like a big shot, right? And then
yeah, obviously.
you're coming up to a green light, okay? So you wait on a green light. Does your car go or does your car stop?
My car goes.
Right. I'm sorry I had to patronize you with that question, but I'm setting up a chain that's going to lead to you eventually agreeing with me is the idea. So you come up to this green light, your car's got the right of way, and then some punk on a skateboard with headphones on, smoking a marijuana cigarette, hops off the curb. He gives you the middle finger. He goes, "What are you going to do, Grandpa? Kill me?" Your car's going too fast. It can't stop in time. And right next to this dude, there's a red video game barrel, which means if you swerve into it, you're gonna die. But only you. Should the self-driving car swerve into the barrel, killing you to save the pedestrian, or should the self-driving car hit the pedestrian?
Hit the pedestrian.
Why do you say that?
Because I hate pedestrians.
Right, but like, do you have a reason?
Well, like, to be honest, like, I stopped listening, so you halfway long story. And then at the end of the story, you presented me with two options, and I just chose the one.
Right, yeah.
Which one did you want me to choose?
I mean, you chose the one I wanted you to choose, but I was hoping you had good reasons instead of
Why
just...
would I want to actually hit a pedestrian?
Because the other option is that you die for his mistake.
Oh, I don't want to die. Why would I die, then?
I'm beginning to see why America's in the state that it's in right now.
Wait, why would I die?
Because there's it's a trolley problem. There's an, like...
Some fake explosion thing?
Yeah, exactly.
Socrates would be like, Ryan, you're an idiot.
Socrates would be like, are you an idiot? Yeah, exactly. Does this seem like a smart question?
Yeah.
Socrates would be like, hey, I want to answer your question, but first, can you tell me what a car is?
What is a car?
What's a skateboard?
What's a video game? What language?
What language are you speaking right now? Sick Transit Gloria.
You would ask that question in English.
Well, he's a smart guy. But I just think like that's been taken out of context. People were like, oh, there's a jaywalker, hit him. No. If the only option for the self-driving car is to hit the jaywalker who jaywalked or crash the car into like a barricade that's next to the jaywalker, I think he should hit the jaywalker because he made the decision to break the... I hesitate to say break the law, but to violate the rules of the road.
Breaking the law.
Judas Priest. Now that's a song, buddy.
What if you had the option to shoot him in the belly before you hit him with the car just to punish him for his crime?
I would not do that.
Wow.
Also, people have started to suggest that I don't think vitamins are real. That's not my takeaway from like Wednesday's show.
Vitamins aren't real?
My takeaway from Wednesday's
real,
show.
Orange juice isn't real. Everyone should be hit by a car.
What's your favorite vitamin or non-vitamin?
Captain America Civil War? What do you mean, what's my favorite vitamin or non-vitamin?
Well, like you said, vitamins aren't real, so like, if you had to choose one that was
I see. Dude, vitamin D?
Ices? Ices aren't a vitamin.
It's
one long fruit-flavored vitamin that happens to be frozen.
The complex of B vitamins I will accept as well. Apart from that...
Including B12.
I'll take B12. I accept vitamin K. I eat enough green leafy vegetables to get enough for myself, but I accept that, you know, they're helpful. I'm just saying the whole emergency, like, vitamin C business, you know, it's got you guys buying into a pseudo... you know, scientific bit of rabble rouse.
Well, pseudo's cough medicine.
So it's like what you do every day.
Yeah, no, exactly. Like, but the difference is I'm not trying to sell you anything. In fact, it is actually free to subscribe if you have your Twitch Prime token, which...
yeah, that's true. That only costs 99 bucks a month, or 95 bucks a year.
Excuse me? What a deal.
Josh, man.
Wait, yours is so much cheaper than mine.
Things are tough in Pittsburgh right now.
Pseudo.
I did get a nice haircut.
Oh, you got a haircut, huh?
No, I didn't. Chad thinks I did.
I got a question for you.
Yeah, tell me what you think about my dick.
Sure. You'd be in Socrates.
Oh,
right
that's
now?
Not a question. Sorry.
What do you? How do you order a haircut? Like when you go into the barber shop.
I go, hey, here's like a picture.
Yeah.
That I showed like three other people that worked here, and they gave me good haircuts.
But is it a picture of you, or is it a picture of?
It started
celebrity.
As someone else, and then it turned into my picture.
I like that. It's like you climbed the ladder from, like, this is what I want, and then eventually you got it, and now you can use that as your photo.
Correct.
That's cool.
Is that all right?
I have a lot of anxiety about that question.
What do you say?
Really
give me the Moby?
A little off the top. not too much or I'll actually be killed, so.
I worry that someday the place I get my haircuts at will go out of business, and then the razor that they happen to use will become non-standardized, and they won't be able to know how to cut my hair anymore.
This is like Robin Williams from Flubber. He's got his own like proprietary razor.
I don't know.
He's not just using the same.
I do a number three on the sides and scissors on top.
Okay, yeah.
And I was given a stern talking to by this one lady that cut my hair. That's like, this is how you order this haircut.
Right.
Because I tried to say it a different way, and everybody got really pissed.
Really?
They got pissed?
From then on, I only say I want a number three and scissors on top, please. And then buzz it in the back, so it's natural.
Maybe the way that you ordered it before is like their code for selling drugs.
Yeah, Nick comes in like, I'll have the little touch up on the side.
I hope you got to go out back.
You want the cocaine?
They gave you like GPS coordinates to the docks.
Yeah.
I hope a number three is the same razor everywhere, because I don't know what I'm gonna do if it's not.
It's gonna be an issue for sure.
It is. I'm counting the days.
It is, you know, it's great about being bald is that if I ever did have to get a haircut, you know, I think they're probably going to know as soon as I take my hat off what I'm looking for. It's not going to be too much confusion. I'm not going to be like, hey, make me look like G-Dragon.
Who's G-Dragon?
Who's G-Dragon?
He's a K-pop superstar.
It's a cool name.
Like
man.
That guy that does the one dance?
Yes, like Psy.
He's a superstar.
Excuse me.
You heard me. What is that thing doing?
Getting a haircut.
Oh, yeah.
I ordered 2 number 9s. I can't even fathom how that makes any sense. But
number 9?
The numbers are a measure of length in 1/8 inches. Oh, God. Now I have to do math?
I mean,
what have you done?
I'm pretty sure you can do 3 times 1/8, right?
3 times 1 is 3.
Yeah, you're almost there, buddy.
He got it.
Halfway there. Okay, all right. Well.
Nope.
Yeah, better hope that place doesn't go out of business. got some skilled.
That's it. That's the only one.
Got some skilled mathematicians working there. I don't understand. Like, do you guys have an electric razor?
Yeah, and I've had the same one since like 2011, and it like doesn't hold like a full charge. So like,
that's how you know it's good.
It's real bad. I hate it.
Well, I've gotten multiple questions for you now. If you let the first one is if you let your beard get too long, does it ever get caught on the hair and then like jam up?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Well, I was just making sure that they're all.
Well, no, it's never jammed up. But like, what happens is like I'll trim like my beard, but like afterwards, like sometimes it only like cuts like part of the hair. So like I'll have like a bunch of just like hair like on my face that's like half cut, and then like I'll rub like my fingers through like my beard, and then like I'll get like I can't describe them anything but like
pubic
hair splinters.
Okay, what?
Oh, I know what those are.
Like on your on your hands.
On my hands.
That's horrible.
I've actually gotten them stuck in my skin. Yeah, that's
what?
Real.
It's a fucking jungle out there, man.
Did you press axe, it just like kicks you back out to like this? That's weird.
Why does the hair pierce your skin? I don't understand that either. I've had one embedded in my pillow before.
The
it's like,
other
are they needles?
The other question I have is, do you understand how those guards work?
No.
Because, like, they always give you a bunch of guards. And I'm like, well, this one's bigger than the other one. That means,
like, Matt Damon guards?
I don't get it.
We're guards.
Oh, I see.
You got it.
Sort of. Like, the bigger the guard, the more hair it leaves. But does it? Because, like, feels like, you know, the razor's still getting in there. It's still
Wait,
doing
what are
the,
you trying to say?
You know, those guards.
What the guards them? Take an average. They don't just straight up cut it at that exact length.
I'm still like I don't.
Some hairs are gonna get cut a little longer than others.
I believe that. I don't understand the. I just don't understand guard technology, I guess.
It's a piece of plastic. It stops the hair from going higher than it.
Can I get much higher?
It's kind of the whole story, really.
Yeah, but I don't like. I don't get it. Like, if you, I need like to see this happen in the HTC Vive to understand the science behind it.
It blocks the hair.
What do you mean?
You can get like an adjustable guard, right?
Yeah, no, I'm aware, but I don't know what I'm adjusting.
Have you ever done a stencil?
The length of beard.
I have.
You don't know what you're adjusting.
I've done stencils before in my life, yeah.
Okay, so like, it's that.
Yeah, but how so though?
The part that doesn't have a blocker is where the hair gets cut.
Part that doesn't have. Okay, yeah, I understand that.
So you're stenciling out your beard with a different size, depending on your preference.
But you're not really stenciling. Like, what if I put the guard and I'm scraping with my beard, right?
Yeah.
And then I just push harder. Isn't that going to push more hair into the guard and thus cut closer to the skin?
You push harder?
Like, these are questions that have pushed harder.
Just
and then
jam it into your chin as hard as you can.
These are questions that have plagued me. Well, I mean, every, like, extra, like, pico newton of force is going to give you, like, another quarter inch off of the hair, right? Or is it no. The harder you push, the less hair is going to get cut because more of it is going to be trapped within the
guard? Are you worried that, like, people...
I'm not worried! I'm just intellectually curious about this.
All right, so your intellectual curiosity is that of... If I use this and like push it a little bit harder, is someone's gonna notice that like?
No, not that someone's gonna notice. I'm just like I want an even cut for me, like intrinsically.
Beards are an analog process.
Okay, explain.
There is no quantification of beard numerology in this explanation.
I'm starting to think this motherfucker might be blowing smoke up my ass.
You're getting a beard. That's gonna have some fucking variance, one way or the other. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if you got.
I'm just saying. I think that your reactions tell me everything I need to know, which is that everybody's just as confused as I am about this situation right now.
I'm not confused.
My eyes are fucking open, Ryan.
Because everybody's going, oh, why would you even ask that question? That's stupid. Nobody's answering the question though.
Like, what's the? All right, you want me to answer a question? What is it?
How do the guards work?
They adjust. So if you want a shorter cut, then you can do that.
Yeah, but like...
Or if you want a longer cut, then you can... It adjusts.
Pretty much has the whole story
Does
now.
Stuff within the guard get cut, or does it get spared?
It depends.
What do you mean it depends? What kind of guard
so
it is?
Some guards...
Oh.
They'll have like two holes. It gets spared because like the longer that you adjust it, the farther away from your face it's gonna be.
It gets spared. It's true. It's like a hostage situation.
Yeah.
Starting to think you guys just as in the dark as I am on this one.
No, you're just trying to put words in my words. So fuck you.
The guard is pressed against your face, which keeps the razor from cutting closer to your skin.
That's what I said. It spares.
That might be what you think you said.
I did. That's what you said.
Excuse me.
How many pico newtons on average do you apply in force to your face?
I believe it's pico newtons.
It's not pico newtons.
Excuse me, Chamber.
Hey, this guy had a question. Let's make fun of him because he said something scientific. I guess his intellectual curiosity is a sin now. No such thing as stupid questions.
Kill the cat.
Oh my lord! I thought we were friends. Apparently, we're
me.
We're enemies.
And who?
You ever done a stencil?
Look, like I still kind? I dispute the stencil argument.
What's the stencil argument?
Because when you take a stencil, you're taking like a pencil and you're writing out a letter. Or you know,
you take stencil. No, a stencil is like if you take a pencil and take off the P and put ST.
Oh shit! He's right.
You know how you get one of those pieces of cardboard and it's like the anarchy symbol, and you want to spray paint that symbol onto a wall.
Right, yeah.
You block out all the parts that are getting sprayed on.
Right.
That aren't the anarchy symbol.
Sure, yeah.
And then only the negative space remains.
Yeah.
That's kind of what you're doing with regard to the hair.
What do you mean by kind of, though?
I mean, it's not literally shooting spray paint on you, if that's what you need for clarification.
I still feel like I've been waiting for I've been shaving for half my life now, right? I thought that, you know, by now we would have
you should have somehow realized what you're not.
Well, you know, like, you know, we go to the eye doctor, you put your face in that thing and they like blow puffs of air in your eye to measure know, stupid shit that doesn't matter. Probably the whole profession's a facade for drug trafficking anyway. Anyway, the point is, why don't they have one of those where you put your face in and then you just go, I want a short beard. And then it gives you, it shaves off like exactly as much as you requested.
So a guard.
Oh, not a guard, but you just rest your face in it. And here's the problem. Like, why am I using an electric razor like a fucking caveman? Like painting my face, you know, like going like a fucking face.
No, I told you we're not.
No, I know, but like it's a face lawnmower is what I'm trying to say. Why don't we have something you just put your face in that cuts it? That just cuts it all off, all at once. Save.
What
does...
if the thing you put your face in came to you?
What do you mean by this? Do you mean came or do you mean arrived?
What if the portability was paramount and you could take it anywhere? Imagine you had to trim your beard in Japan, where you don't currently live.
Is this guy talking about the Nintendo Switch?
What
is he making a joke? I don't understand.
I don't understand the entire conversation.
Okay,
right
see,
now.
What I'm trying to suggest is why don't you have like a little, like a helmet that you can put on, but for your beard.
Because then, that's fucking lame.
How is that lame at all?
A helmet for your beard? Listen
no,
to
no,
yourself,
but you put
man.
It on, you put it on for 2 seconds, and then it goes, like, welcome back. What kind of beard would you like today? And you go, I want my beard to be a little shorter. And then it just goes, zip, and then all of your beard hair gets trimmed at once, instead of you having to be like, I want a shorter beard. You know, for hours at a time.
Hours.
I would like to hear that brimp and then it's all cut part. That's
yeah,
satisfying.
Just like one brimp and then you're good.
I don't know. It sounds kind of weird. How would they do it with lasers or something?
No, with the like a series of razors yeah. that
no,
you
I'll see. What you happens. Want you want a series of razors instead of a series of lasers? You're on crack.
What? What? How much do you want to?
See the Resident Evil movie because that's how that would end.
Exactly correct.
I've seen Saw.
Yeah, have you seen Resident Evil though, where they cut the man into tiny cubes?
Yeah,
it did. But he wasn't wearing like a fucking laser hat.
He had a helmet on because
if he had a helmet on, he
you know, this reminds me of what David Bowie said in The Prestige.
Bowie.
When he was David Bowie when he was playing Nikola Tesla. Nick Tesla. He said,
"Is that like Adam Sessler's brother?"
Hey, I'm Nick Tesla, landmark scientist. I also really like birds. He
Look
was
at
like,
this fucking bird.
Hey, people here in Colorado don't like me anymore. So here's this box, Hugh Jackman, that you can use for magic. Hopefully magicians like this stuff more than people in Colorado Springs. I'm paraphrasing a little bit, but it was something along those lines.
Yeah.
Did they?
Nah, well, I mean, I don't know. It depends. I mean, he did sell out, like, a lot of his shows, but then Hugh Jackman was like, I don't know if I'm going to be Hugh Jackman or if I'm going to be Hugh Jackman that's in the box at the end of the show. So it was like a whole... Have you seen The Prestige, Nick?
Yeah, yeah. I'm just trying to get it from your perspective because it seems like there was more going on there than I was aware of at the time I saw it.
Well, you know, it's like well, a retro futuristic... Have you seen The Prestige, Josh?
No.
Well, dude, it's really good!
Well, all right, why do you want to watch it with me then?
I'll watch it with you.
Really?
As long as you can phrase that sentence in a way that doesn't make you sound like Jar Jar Binks next time, I'm all in.
Misa want you to watch it with Misa.
Thank you. It's exactly the opposite of what I requested, but in many ways that shows intent, so I'm okay.
Yeah.
Yo, the Prestige is real good, dude. It also, it added a lot to my, the favorite folder I have on my computer, which is video files of Michael Caine eating at cafes and Christopher Nolan films.
Oh, it's a Christopher Nolan film?
It is a Christopher Nolan film.
Nolan also did that one Memento, right?
Oh, yeah, dude.
I didn't see that.
Can I blow your mind? He did The Dark Knight.
Nah.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, huh?
Yeah. And The Dark Knight Rises.
Wait, then who did The Dark Knight Rises after?
Wait, doesn't he begin at some point?
Yeah, he did that one too.
What's the order that Batman goes in?
Batman. And then Batman Returns. Then Batman Forever. Then Batman and Robin.
Batman and Robin.
Then Batman Begins. Then he becomes the Dark Knight and he rises.
Yeah, see that one I don't get. Batman has a chronology until that point.
What happened to Batman of Fire and Ice?
Batman of Fire and Ice. What does that mean?
That's the one. Yeah. What is this thing tell? Shut up!
What does it mean?
What does it all mean, Basil?
Well, there's Mr. Freeze, but like, who's the fire part?
Poison Ivy.
Poison Ivy?
Poison Ivy would die in a forest fire.
Yeah, but she's got a fire crotch.
Oh, that's hot.
What does that mean?
She got red pubes.
How do you know? Did you see them?
You haven't seen the movie?
Wait, I didn't see your pubes in the movie. Pubes?
No, you gotta look closely, man.
Yeah, is that right?
Were they peeking out over the top of her plant leg?
Yeah, they were all over her head.
Oh, that's cool.
Wait. That's cool.
I don't understand. Like, if we're gonna talk about stupid film names... Like, Batman is actually in the clear as far as I'm concerned. You know,
Batman is a cool film name.
Well, I'm just saying, like, all the Batman film names, they sort of make sense to me. Whereas, like, fucking the Spider-Man films, Spider-Man 2, Spider-Man, listen to me here. Spider-Man, Spider-Man 2, Spider-Man 3, The Amazing Spider-Man, The Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Okay.
There's five Spider-Man films.
At one point, he becomes amazing, which is a whole different spider.
Yeah, but then, like, starting this summer, he's Homecoming.
And you don't like that.
Is he amazing as well, or is that a separate issue?
I don't think he's amazing anymore. He's a man who's a spider. He's Spider-Man.
People say that he's more closely related to Ultimate in this one.
Is that the scuttlebutt on Ain't It Cool News?
Ultimate Spider-Man.
He's more closely related to Ultimate.
Are there other words he can be other than Ultimate or Amazing?
Sticky.
Spectacular.
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 I like how descriptive the author is with writing this character. He's got so many great words.
Well, I mean, let me put it this way.
He's got the best words.
The man's name is not like the amazing Peter Parker or like, you know...
What is that? Like,
Arachneon. Like, his name is Spider-Man. Like, they pretty much planned it from the start. It's going to be pretty much self-explanatory.
That's really good. It's accessible to the audience.
I agree. He's a man who's a spider.
What was the other name you just gave? Arachnotron?
Yeah, something like that. Something to do with Iraq, I was thinking.
Like boobs?
Excuse me? Oh, like, I see.
Middle Eastern boobs?
Right, Baghdad. I get you. I get you.
Don't tell me what to do with Dad.
I don't get it.
Hey, let me into the hush fight. Dang. They didn't.
You don't deserve the hush fight.
Arachnids are bugs, not insects.
I gotta say, though, like, the worst naming convention is definitely Fast and the Furious. Fast and the Furious.
It's a time mission.
Too Fast, Too Furious. Followed by the Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift. Followed by... The Fast and Furious, followed by Fast Five. It's like, can you just stick to it for 2 fucking seconds? Like, stand by your principles?
What is this? This one is like now Fate, Furious 8.
Is the Fate of the Furious or something?
Yeah. It's weird, isn't it?
Well, it's fitting they could put the number back in, right?
Oh, he's right!
Most of the whole premise of that movie series was how they titled them. Like, that's what they bring to the filmmaking genre is the titles with numbers.
I actually watched Tokyo Drift this weekend.
Yeah, they go sideways a lot.
It was actually horrible.
It wasn't good.
No, it's so bad. There's one, like, it was on TV when I had to do, like, some work. So I was sitting there watching Tokyo Drift. And there's a great moment. I guess I've just been kicked out of this run. There's a great moment where, like, the protagonist is having this heart-to-heart with this lady. And, you know, they're like, oh, I guess I'll just only know who I am when I drift. And then... No.
What?
Straight up. And then, to add to this, they're having the conversation while drifting. So, like, in between this, like, really introspective discussion they're having, it's intercut with shots of them on, like, this dark road, just, like, turning literally, like, 270 degrees around a turn, and then, like, looking each other in the eyes and smiling, and it is played extremely straight. Like, they're not like, hey, isn't it weird that we're having this conversation while we're drifting? Like, the way that, I don't know, like a Seth Rogen movie would do it, or like Deadpool or something like that. Instead, they're like, nah, dude, this is fucking sick. They're having this heart-to-heart while they drift.
When did it come out?
2006, maybe?
I wonder if they were ever not in a car in that movie.
In Tokyo Drift, there are a few segments where they're on foot and either fighting or shooting at each other.
Huh. Did you like it when they shot each other?
That was way worse than the driving parts, which were also really bad. I also feel like, you know, at the end of the movie, it puts up like a little splash screen that goes like, hey, don't do this. It's not safe. And I get that. It's a movie. But at the same time, earlier in the film, though, the dude goes, hey, why didn't the cops chase me back there? And his friend goes, they only got Honda Civics. If you do over 180 kilometers, they won't even try to catch you. And then the other guy goes, I'm beginning to like this country already. Can't help but feel that maybe the disclaimer should have showed up after that very line. I wonder how much trouble this has caused for Japanese police over the years. They're like, what do you mean if we go over 180 kilometers, we're not even going to try to catch you? We're going to throw you in jail.
Motherfucker.
You only had a Honda Civic, though. Is that true?
Like, yeah, what's your roles on Honda Civics here?
Well, I saw it in the Tokyo Drift movie. Also, Lil Bow Wow is in it.
I like that character as the guy that only knows things about Japan that are through Tokyo Drift. I think there's probably some good stuff in there.
Trying to think about what else. Lil Bow Wow's got some good lines. Forget what he says. He's like, Japanese food is like womp. And I can't remember. It's like a pithy little line. He's like, Japanese food is like womp 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 womp. Yeah, either womp womp or womp womp womp. And I'm like, yeah, dude. Hell
so
yeah.
So he's a dad from Peanuts.
Exactly. Exactly correct.
I'd be fine if he just said that it's like womp. That would be a good story for me.
That's what he said. He said it's like womp.
It's like womp.
Am I Dark Judas now?
Dark Judas. My womp is like womp, 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 womp.
Somebody find the quote from IMDb.
Womp, 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 womp.
Lil Bow Wow also, I mean, like, his character in the movie is that he's like steals things from people and then sells it back to other people. Oh, yeah, there it is. Dude, you're going to love this. And it justifies the anecdote. Japanese food's like the army. Don't ask, don't tell.
I don't get it.
Oh, because he doesn't know what the food is.
Exactly. And also, remember...
What's he doing in Tokyo?
Yeah, they never explained, I think, why Lil Bow Wow's in Tokyo.
He's here for his cameo.
I don't even remember why the main character was in Tokyo. I think it's like his dad was in like the Navy or something, and he's causing trouble back in America. So it's like a Fresh Prince of Bel-Air situation. He's like, you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Tokyo.
So like, did he live with his like family in Tokyo?
Yeah, he like lived with his dad, but his dad was an alcoholic who like banged a bunch of strippers. It was really
and
like
one of the strippers was Tokyo.
No, wait, prostitutes. Sorry, not strippers. I mean, like, you know, who knows, but...
So what is he doing? Is the dad in Tokyo?
Yeah, the dad's in Tokyo.
Okay.
I don't really know why. It seems like his only job is to... Well, he's probably, like, doing something in the army, but then also he spends, like, all his time fixing up this Camaro that is really, like, a Chekhov's gun sort of situation.
Who's Chekhov?
You know, it's
is
like...
Is another character?
Like, wow, this dang beat-up Camaro would be real nice if we could ever get it off the ground, and then wouldn't you know it, at the end, when they're street racing for their lives... Camaro turns out to be a little relevant.
Are you sure?
Don't you see race for pink slips, not lives?
No, this was about their lives. Like, a bunch of people definitely died in Tokyo Drift.
So it drifts really well, though.
I don't know. I mean, he did drift. They were going down this hill. And Lil Bow Wow was like, he chose this. This is his mountain. Ain't nobody else ever made it to the bottom alive. And I'm like, damn,
his
dude.
Mountain?
The Japanese government should really, like, decommission that road then. Because that seems highly dangerous.
There's something strangely beautiful about someone so passionate about the very specific activity of driving sideways.
There's nothing.
I kind of had some admiration.
There's actually nothing beautiful about it whatsoever. It's the dumbest thing.
They really love going sideways.
The whole movie went sideways from the opening credits, as far as I'm concerned. Anyway,
that as well.
Tokyo Drift is the only Fast and Furious film I've seen, and
nuh-uh.
I watched the Fast and the Furious 1 when I was like 13. I remember nothing.
You didn't
nothing
watch like 6 on an airplane sometime?
No, I mean, I'd be missing out. Until
dude, you should go like watch like a couple of them. I mean, they're dumb as shit.
Well, that's
but, like,
the thing.
It's
like, they're like pro wrestling, right? They're like deliberately dumb
PAX
things
East.
That smart people
go to
like.
PAX East, you promised me that you will watch some sort of Fast and Furious.
I'm not gonna. Everyone's trying to get us to. Everyone's trying to get us to. Hey, you want to fly to PAX East and then watch a movie? No, I can just. I'll just watch it here. I'm not gonna fly
to
Boston.
Anyway, what are you gonna watch? What are you gonna watch on the flight?
Whatever's on the Seatback Entertainment, as always.
So fucking Tokyo Drift or another Fast and Furious.
If there's Fast and the Furious on the Seatback Entertainment, I'll take a look. But honestly,
I'm telling you that there is.
There probably won't be. It's been forever since the last one came out. It's been like a year and a half since the last one came out.
There always is.
I've never seen one either, actually. I've seen Gone in 60 Seconds though. That was good.
That's basically like the same
movie.
I've been
mad at you my entire life.
Oh.
Just kidding. I was madder when you didn't invite me to your wedding.
That's fair.
Oh, I thought you were talking to me.
No, no. You probably would have invited me to your wedding.
Well, yeah, if I knew you at the time, maybe. But I didn't invite really anybody to my wedding, so no.
Yeah, but it would have been me.
It would have been me.
Yeah, okay. I'll invite you now.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Wow, fuck you, NL. Oh, I guess we just sending out invites here. Everyone's in their invite safe space. Oh, you get an invite. You get an invite. Sorry, didn't mean to hurt your feelings, snowflake.
Oh, no.
Josh, me and you could just get married, and then Ryan couldn't come.
You couldn't stop me from coming in that situation.
Wait, I don't get it.
Yeah, me either.
I would be arriving.
Arrival.
Yeah, that's a good movie.
I watched that recently.
I didn't see it.
Nick didn't think it was that good.
I thought it was all right. It just wasn't my favorite thing. You guys are like really worked up about it.
I wasn't really worked up about it.
I heard that you were really
I'm an adult. I was. You go to the movie, like, oh, gotta get some Arrival wallpaper or something. I just came back.
Dude, that'd be fucking sick.
Came
back. Wallpaper
is like
a big thing. Like, do people just like, you know, when they're 12, just go online and look for like wallpapers for their desktop still?
Dude, you just said it right there.
Like, I mean, still do. I look for abstract
really?
Shapes.
Holy fuck. That guy's so fast.
Or I make my own.
Huh. I just keep going with, like, the default.
Dude,
like,
I mean,
stopped that shit.
I'm gonna be real with you. I think wallpaper is one of, if not the biggest industry on planet Earth.
Like wallpaper?
Wallpaper. Yeah. Mark Wallpaper.
Mark Wallpaper?
Why do you believe that, though?
It's just, you know, the writing's on the wall.
Oh.
What?
Like a stencil.
It's more like a paper you glue to your wall.
I don't get it. Sorry, I never read chat. But suck it.
The world.
The world is a vampire.
What does he mean when he says that? Because I think we should suck this up before Robert gets on the show, because he's going to have some strong opinions. Because he likes the vampires.
So get rid of it before he sucks it.
Well, I'm just trying to sort it out.
I think it's, like, it sucks, like, your life away.
That's what he
like
says?
Like, the world, it's the world is a vampire. Like, what does a vampire do?
Why are we listening to this, like, multi-millionaire and
no, what is a vampire
male
do?
Model? Okay, vampire, what do?
They suck.
Number one, suck blood.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Which you need blood for, like, living and stuff sometimes, right?
Well, not everything. It's a very sentient.
The world is a vampire sent to drain. Secret destroyers hold you up to the flames. And what do I get for my pain? Betrayed desires and a piece of the game.
Okay, yeah.
Even though I know, I suppose I'll show all my cool and cold like old Job.
Old Jeb.
Excuse me?
That's what it says. I don't know. Do those words make any sense?
No. I hate this elevator one.
Yeah, dude.
Even though I know, I suppose I'll show all my cool and cold like old Job.
Like old Jab. That's, you know, like Billy Corgan. He doesn't say Job. He goes, Jab. You know,
he says Jab.
You can really make it rhyme with anything if you Corganize it.
Corganize it.
We're the Corganizers.
Didn't we already have a Bill Corgatron in the past?
We are hiding.
Yo, there's a good character, dude, that will, like, completely resonate with about 1% of the general population. Billy Gorgonite.
Yeah, like Billy Mitchell and Billy Corgan and also corrugated cardboard?
It's everybody named Billy ever, plus a Gorgonite from Small Soldiers.
Who goes by Billy?
Little kids.
And, like, sometimes adults.
If you're named Billy and you don't own, like, a refrigerator repair business, like, you're really missing out, aren't you?
Yeah, like, Billy...
Should be like,
what about
Billy's cold R's?
Billy's cold R's.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
What about Billy Bush? I feel like that's it's a Bush thing to do, is to be like, you know, my name is William, but you can call me Billy.
Chili Billy.
I'd have a beer with him.
Oh, Chili Billy is really good.
Chili Billy is way better. What about Billy Crystal? What about Billy Crystal?
I mean, you brought him up. What was the crystal for? Crystal meth?
Oh, yeah. More like Billy Crystal meth. I mean, if you heard some of the things that I've heard,
he is very
passionately in favor of mandatory minimum sentences for repeat drug offenders.
Mandatory minimum sentence structure.
We follow that prerogative.
We have to have at least 20 words per sentence.
Wow.
That's a lot, right?
That is a tall order.
You have to keep on talking.
Semicolon.
Keep on talking and keep on talking and until the sentence is done.
What about Billy Bob Thornton? Everyone's always like, what about Billy? Okay, sure. You got us, I guess.
Billy Idol?
Is Billy Bob Thornton the worst person who's ever fucked Angelina Jolie? This is a new board game I'm prototyping right now.
Is it always Angelina Jolie?
Yes, and it's always Billy Bob Thornton.
Oh, okay. So this is just actually a yes or no question, and that's the entire board
game. You know,
game.
I haven't really specced out the rest of the rules.
Okay. Now I'm naked, nothing but an animal.
Who else has she fucked?
But can you fake it for just one more show?
It's kind of a personal question, Josh.
Well, you asked me who's the worst person that she's
fucked. No, I asked you, is Billy Bob Thornton the worst person that she's fucked?
Well, who else has she fucked? I need to know.
I feel relatively confident that she has had intercourse with Brad Pitt at least once.
How many times?
I mean, you didn't see penetration.
I didn't see her fuck Billy Bob Thornton either. I just assumed they did because, you know.
Well, why would you assume? You don't know.
Well, because they were wearing vials of each other's blood around their necks. It's like, that's way more intimate than intercourse. That's like.
Well, yeah, because they were so intimate with that, then, like, they didn't need anything else.
They didn't need anything else?
Yeah, they got all the blood out of their system and they were dead.
Now they're vampires. Right. This goes back to
right,
Billy
it's a callback.
Wait, what if the world is just. You know, words for Billy Bob Thornton and Angelina
Jolie. The world
Jolie.
Is Angelina Jolie and Billy Bob Thornton's relationship.
Yes. That's why it's a vampire.
Which is why we can't stop going in circles in this fucking conversation.
We got to the end.
It's rare that I find myself thinking that we've gone off the rails.
No, we've won. We did it.
I just wish you would discuss
on the rails.
I wish you would discuss
We brain flooded him,
too. I wish you would discuss the issue at hand, is all I'm trying to say. And failing at. But it's this damn mandatory minimum sentence structures making it so hard to talk.
Mandatory minimum sentences.
Discuss.
My new weed strand.
Dude. I tell you, well, actually, I said it on Skype, which means you didn't see it, I'm sure. But yeah. We ate pho at this place the other day.
Can he use it in the
sentence? Can you prove it?
Can he prove it also?
Right next to the pho place, little establishment by the name of Budzilla Lounge.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Tell me about Budzilla.
I don't know anything about it, except that it was called Budzilla Lounge, and there was a large marijuana leaf on the glass. That's...
Wow.
Well, like a picture of a large marijuana leaf.
What would their mothers think?
Damn, dude.
This is where their lives ended up. Picture of a marijuana leaf on the front of a store.
It's a pretty good name, though, you got to admit.
Budzilla. Is there like a joint Mothra?
Budzilla versus joint Mothra. Okay, yeah. I knew there was some gold to mine here somewhere. There we go.
Well, I'm imagining the body of a moth, but it's made of a joint.
I mean, I think I told you this before. At least I've bitched about it in the Google chat that Josh and I have with some other of our mutual friends. But, like, that's why I can't wait for marijuana legalization. So that you have to go buy...
So you can smoke it all day long.
Oh, dude, so I can just get ripped out of my gourd and,
rip
like...
shit on ham.
Dude.
Dude.
Anyway, dude. But, like, dude. Right now, there's, like, a million dispensaries in Vancouver, and they're all called, like, you know, the Can of Buddies. And you're like, okay, I get it. That's cute. They're all wordplay, though, and I don't respect that. I want people to have to buy weed from a place that's uncool. I want them to have to go to a place that's called, like, you know, Government Dispensary Bureau number 94. I think that's gonna... Because I want to see any undeserved joy sucked out of the world, if possible. Like,
oh, right, okay.
If I ever have to have a conversation where somebody goes, check it out, I'm smoking some Genghis Bon, then, like, I lose. In my own twisted world, I lose. I want them to have to be like, yeah, you know, I got some, you know, Epsilon 40 from the Government Weed Bureau. And then I'm like, okay, now we're on the same level. You know, what's your portfolio look like?
The relationship between marijuana and puns. Like?
I don't respect products that are named after puns.
But why do potheads use puns so prodigiously?
I have to say, in the interest of you know, being equal opportunity here, there are a lot of breweries that do it too.
Yep. Yeah, well, okay. So why does anyone use?
I think it's really just because you need some way to like diversify your product. And if you had the choice, you're like, oh, this is called the Green Monster, and this one is called like Elijah Wood's eyelids. Which one are you gonna get?
Elijah Wood's eyelids.
I would be getting I gotta know what Elijah Wood's eyelids are like.
No question. All right, that's a fairly compelling argument.
It's the same, like,
is that false advertising, though?
Oh, I mean, if it contains at least 1% of Elijah Wood's eyelids, then the FDA can't touch him.
Yeah. Okay, it's 1%. And beyond that, it's just diluted.
You know what's a much better name for a marijuana cigarette than Elijah Wood's eyelids?
Islands?
Elijah Wood's eyelids.
Hear me out here, Doug. Okay, and you know what's even better than Elijah Wood's eyelids?
What?
Frodo Schwaggins.
It does say swag in it.
Now I see why they do it. It's so easy.
It's very, you feel smug now too, right?
I'm probably the next Shakespeare, to be honest with you. Anyway, no. I mean, I think the same thing when I go to the grocery store and a food is called like, you know, a milk brand is like, holy cow. I'm like, I'm not buying that. I'm getting Avalon.
Who's Avalon?
Avalon's I guess it's a local dairy or something, but like.
Like a streamer, right? Go ahead.
I really needed you to carry the remainder of that joke because I had no idea what you were talking about there.
I loved it.
What if you just named your weed Dildo? You think people would buy it more or less?
More. What if you named your dog Dodo? Like, would people pet it more or less?
More.
Yeah.
Obviously.
I mean, we've got... What if I asked you what the last name of the actor who gets a brand new car at the start of the 1995 or 1999 film Pay It Forward was? You would say?
Pierce Brosnan.
It's Moore. It's Jay Moore.
That's what I said.
I mean, you said Pierce Brosnan. What if you named your dog...
Was his Pierce name Brosnan. Moore Orlis? Brosnan.
Pierce Brosnan. I bet, I don't know.
How much would you pet a dog named Pierce Brosnan?
About the same as any other dog.
The most scientific unit you have.
Okay, though, I guess like 1.0 times 10 to the 0. Then multiply that by N, where N is the cuteness factor.
Are you saying you wouldn't pet that dog?
I'm saying I would pet it one proportional to the cuteness it has.
I thought you multiplied it by 0 at one point.
Excuse me? Anything to the power of 0 is 1, Nicholas? Nicholas Tesler?
Twizzler. Nicholas Twizzler.
You guys have anybody on your Facebook that posts like those math problems that are just clickbait to get likes and stuff on your fan page?
Yeah.
It's like, you know, they give you like a very basic skill testing question and then go like, you know, what's 60 times 3 minus 4 plus 2? Share if you're smart enough to get the answer. And then there's like a million and a half comments. We are fucked as a society.
I noticed that. Yeah.
Like, I mean, this conversation about Frodo Schwaggins is like definitely up there as well. Like, that's the damnation. Well, I would like to think so because it directly profits us, but...
Yeah.
We balance out the negative element of
society. We balance out the negative elements.
I think the fundamental problem with human beings is that if somebody tells us, like, only...
Is that we're not made out of, like, 90% weed. That's
that we're not token right now, bro!
Hell yeah, dude. Fuck you, Justin Trudeau.
He's very handsome, though.
Now, this all being... I think the fundamental problem with human beings is that if someone tells us only 3% of people can solve this, and we solved it, we're inclined to believe them without any other further evidence. I'm thinking for like 50% of the population, if you went like, hey, what's 7 times 4? Only 3% of the population could solve this. They would be like, oh, 28! Where's my certificate?
So anyway. We just desperately want to be better than other people, that's all.
Yeah, but like, it's weird. I'm trying to tease out where the joke in this is for me. And I think
it's not a math problem, it's a psychology experiment.
Oh, I mean, I definitely agree with that. But I also think, like, people were like, don't call me a nerd. But then at the same time, they're like, check it out. Can you get 100% on this math quiz designed for fifth graders? Because I did.
They're like, don't call me a nerd, but like, I just upped my nerd cred.
Yeah, exactly. Look, I'm so smart, I didn't even try. I knew the teachers were wrong.
Yeah.
Don't call me a nerd. I'm bigger. Watches Black Mirror.
You see that
once.
One every so often. It would be good. A whole bunch of words and letters and numbers all jumbled up with like the beginning and the end of the word.
Right.
Were normal, and it would just be. Isn't it amazing the human brain can read this despite all of the changes? You know, something to that effect.
Wow, dude.
And that would get reshared so many times.
It just makes you want to fucking get a fat-ass doobie and then spark it up, am I right? Like...
Well, the problem was I had already done that.
I mean, was it a day that ends in Y?
I don't get it. Every day ends in Y,
only 3% of people do, man. Don't be hard on yourself.
All right. That's cool. Can I just be Stone Nick sometimes as a character?
Depends what state do you live in.
You have to come to work stoned.
I gotta go to Massachusetts.
Right, yeah.
Why, what's in Massachusetts?
More like massive, huge hits off of this functional glassware, if you know what I mean.
Did you just make that up?
I mean, people are telling me I stole the Frodo Schwaggins joke, which...
Massive, huge like, hits.
If so, I apologize.
I can't believe you stole that. You stole it from the internet?
I really hope I didn't steal it from, like, Louis C.K., because he's got a history.
You should go check the licensing agreement on that joke before you say it out loud. Maybe it's got Creative Commons licensing. Who knows?
Reusability. NL is definitely on the pot. Dude. You can't be on something if you're never off it.
Like my dick!
Or this, marijuana cigarette.
You would never.
Dude, but have you ever tried it? What's it like?
It'll expand your mind, man.
Yeah.
It might do that, I guess. I don't know.
What's next on the docket?
Well, I was going to make a bold statement first.
Okay.
Bold, as in you smoked it?
Mm. No. Here's... Dude, if you've ever smoked weed, hear me out here. You should be president. Just for, like...
A day.
Maybe like a year or two. Till we work everybody through. Just to see what the world would be like.
Why?
Why not?
That's the dumbest shit I ever heard you say.
Our problem, dude, is in society we spend way too much time asking why. Not enough time asking why not. You know what? Starting tomorrow, Josh? Lady Gray's president.
Lady Gray, you hear that? No, because I'm wearing headphones. She didn't hear you.
Your cat is wearing headphones?
No, I'm wearing headphones.
How would she not hear you then?
I'm wearing headphones.
Oh, right. Right. Yeah, okay. I understand.
Yeah, but how would she not hear you?
Dude, I am way too intoxicated to be having this conversation right now.
She's bad kitties. It's so cute, like, when she tries to, like, bite me because she doesn't have any teeth. So just, like, she gums me.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
Does she think she's biting you?
Yeah, she thinks she's biting. I mean, she bites at me, but then it's just like, it's all gums.
And then you could just like slide your finger away from it. And
yeah,
then
she bites
weird.
At
it's a really
me.
Weird feeling. Yeah.
Cat gums.
Low in the world, a little cat gum.
Alone in your mouth is a little cat gum.
Lady Gray, come here.
I feel like there's also like a Beatles parody in there, you know, like a. Nobody ever gums me like she gums.
Lady.
Ooh, she gums. She gums me gums. You know, something like
She'll
that.
She'll be gumming round.
Yeah, that's... Dude! Now we're talking. Oh, Lord. Are you here? I think I'm being teleported back to the Middle Ages here.
What's happening?
There's a Kate got a recorder, I think, and she's playing it in the background here.
Oh, are you like in the village square now?
I feel like I might have been teleported back to
the village square.
I can't
figure
out. Everything's
gonna change.
How to get out of this floor, dude? Oh my lord!
I gotta get my cat.
Kate, are you taking me back to 18th century Nottingham?
Nope. Yeah, I took some recorder class.
All right, this might be the best or the worst content that's ever made it to Twitch. I'm kind of excited to see how this works out.
Ask her if she knows BreeDD.
Here she goes. This is the worst stream we've ever done. What is this show coming to? Oh.
What is happening?
I have no idea. Oh, okay, it's under the sea. I hear it. Wow, Kate, that's pretty good.
What just happened?
Four years of music education at Canada's most prestigious university doesn't get you too far on the recorder, apparently. Oh man, that was a trip. That was a trip down memory lane.
That was under the key of C.
Oh. Wow, I had a great time there. I gotta be honest. I'm like almost done this run, by the way.
I think I'm turning off Isaac. I don't feel like playing it anymore. Bye, Isaac.
I took classes. I also went to a summer camp
for recorder.
Yeah.
Jeez, somebody out there making a killing. Recorder summer camp.
I'm pretty good, but you made me laugh. That's why I had to. I couldn't express.
Kate, you know, in fifth grade, I played Ode to Joy from Beethoven's Fifth Symphony in front of the whole school on a recorder.
Yeah, that's amazing.
As long as we're talking about, like, the most embarrassing moments from our past lives.
Why is it
sounds pretty lame.
Because it probably sounded like garbage.
Yeah,
but
it's a duet, so if you want, we can get another recorder.
Oh, nothing would interest me more.
And then we can duet a whole new world together. Right?
And then we can do it.
With your wife. Does Kate have an automatone?
What is that?
She says, what is that?
That's the little, it's like a music note, and you squeeze its jaw, and it goes, and then you can slide your finger up and down the neck of it.
Your neck.
Thank you. Really like this run to be over, to be honest with you, but it's like...
It's just a little digital instrument. It's kind of funny.
I'm doing now is just petting this cat on stream.
That's fine. I mean, oh no, we're taking time away from Ultimate Chicken Horse, a game we played another 10,000 hours of.
Is that what we're playing next?
Yeah, that's up next.
Have I played that before?
Probably like 20 times, but you still don't know how to get into a lobby, so...
Oh, yeah.
You might want to boot it up right now if you want.
Yeah, I was just going to say, they still have that, like, that lame rule?
Yeah, sure, whatever.
Which one's that?
Yep.
The lame rule?
Pretty much how I expected that conversation to go. Man. That was a good
time, I guess
they
can't hear me anymore or something.
I can hear you.
I can hear you.
Chad loved it, Kate.
Chad liked it?
Yeah.
Chad, did you like it?
You should come on and play the Jurassic Park theme song for us on Wednesday's show.
Yeah, if it's a recorder that anything it can be played on recorder, I'll play it. I have to practice the Gwent one now.
Yeah.
So I can play on Sunday.
La 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 la. Wait, which one's the Gwent one?
I know it's a recorder that's playing in the background.
Can you?
People want more.
You know.
What are you gonna play, Kate?
You do know.
Okay. I'm just gonna look at the score. All right. I see what it is. You got it yet? It's Kate's weird tunes. Close your chats.
Oh god. It squeals when she laughs.
Oh lordy. That was a good one.
What song was she playing?
That's I Just Can't Wait to Be King from the Lion King soundtrack. Do the neighbors hate you? I don't give a shit. I hate them. We're on the same page. Robert, you can get in here if you want to get in here. This is the worst NLS ever, and I love it. What you tell? This is the greatest NLSS ever.
I performed in front of thousands of people.
Yeah, well, look, you're doing the same thing right now.
No, I'm saying right now. I performed.
Oh, there you go. Put it on your resume. An audience of 7,000 people.
Yeah, that's an honor, man. Thanks, Chet, for listening to my... I haven't played recorder since I was 8 years old, but... You know, I try my best to entertain.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Rob?
Robert. I hope Rob comes in with like a fucking cello or something right now. That would just... That would elevate it beyond its current level.
Yo, during my stream, when someone subscribes, I'll play more.
There you go. Kate's doing a subathon. She'll... regale you with some recorder tunes, every subscriber.
I heard my name being called.
Rabbit. Hey.
How's it going?
Did you bring the cholo?
Did I bring the cholo?
Cello, I said cello.
Oh, no. I brought neither of those things.
Hey, Rob.
Yeah, what's up?
What's up?
is that coming back?
No.
Are we doing that now? What are other, like, mid-2000s, like, commercial memes, because I know they existed. Like
Gatorade, is it in you?
Mm, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Oh, Geico stuff.
Oh,
what can Brown do for you?
Lost another loan to Ditech.
Yeah. All right.
Cat, bite me.
Jesus.
Yeah. It bit me. It gummed me.
Well, what are you, Brad Pitt in Fight Club?
Oh, we. Oh, speaking of which, Robert.
Yeah.
What's up? Okay. Is Billy Bob Thornton the worst person that has fucked Angelina Jolie?
Well, so are we not considering the people that we don't know about?
Yeah, I mean, you gotta have some proof.
Yeah, all right. Well, then, I don't know. He's pretty handsome, actually, despite his silly name.
I still think we haven't seen full penetration, so we don't know 100% it happened.
I mean, they were banging for sure.
Thank
Why
you.
Why do you say for sure?
You don't put somebody else's blood around your neck until they put their legs around your neck.
That's a good point.
I'm sorry about this Isaac run, by the way. Like,
what'd she ever do with his vial of blood since they, you know...
Drank it.
She just drank it? What, is she a vampire?
That's how you dispose of
it. No, okay. Look.
No, the world is the vampire.
Right, exactly.
Oh, like Yggdrasil, the world tree.
To be honest, I hope she smorked it.
You just wanted
dip
the memes.
Joint and blood.
Hell yeah, little blood joint.
I actually came in with two potential topics of discussion.
Sure, yeah.
Okay.
You can't wait to hear them.
I can't say them because I have to ask you what you think about the Smashing Pumpkin lyrics before we get to that.
Okay, go for it.
All right, so even though I know, I suppose I'll show.
Even though I know, someday we all gotta go, but as long as we leave in thieving, we'll be leaving with some kind of dough. So until that day we expire and turn to vapor, me and my capa will be somewhere stacking plenty papers. Keeping it real, packing steel, and getting high, because life's a bitch, and then you die.
Right. Did you write that yourself?
That's from the song Life's a Bitch, and Then You Die by Nas, featuring AZ.
That was really good.
That you
came
wrote
up
that.
With that, like, right off the top of your head, honestly.
Well, yeah, no, that was a freestyle rap.
I can't believe you guys actually thought that was Ryab.
That was a freestyle rap, just like Today Is a Good Day by me, and not by
Ice Cube. Right, yeah, you did that, yeah. I remember that.
So, yeah, the entirety of my point was in the last three words of that, which I didn't say. Even right, though I know, I suppose...
More like the last three herbs of
that. Oh! Herbie Fully Loaded is a quiplash prompt from a long time ago. Wait, Nick, you invited me to play Ultimate Chicken Horse, but I'm in here.
Oh, Josh isn't here, so just send invites over and over again.
Oh, I got you.
I'm also not in there yet, but I am fighting Isaac. Yeah.
Even though I know, I suppose I'll show all my cool and cold, like old job.
What? Like?
Oh, maybe it's Job.
Yeah, were they
like
trying
old
to say
Job?
Job? Yeah, like Job from the Bible, right? Like that's
all
is,
my cool and
is
cold.
Is the J
like
capitalized?
Job. No, it isn't.
Oh, okay.
That's well, why I didn't think to even guess.
Does he say Job in the song?
Like, I don't remember.
I've never heard it. Honestly.
Yeah, I don't, it doesn't ring a bell
well,
either.
But at the end of the song, he says, tell me I'm the chosen one. Jesus was the only son for you. So maybe it is Job.
Yeah, it's definitely Job if he's referencing Jesus shortly thereafter.
Shit, he's got us.
You guys just... really liked how confusing it was when it was old job.
Do you guys want to like just not run ads and instead play Ultimate Chicken Horse?
I assume that's what we're doing. All it's right. Like three pennies anyway. Who gives a fuck?
Oh my God.
This is a good point, honestly. I don't run ads anymore.
I run ads because sometimes I gotta piss.
Yeah. I still don't run ads, though, when I gotta piss.
Why
I
not?
Should.
It's on your ads. Fuck your ads.
Chat would be all right with it, probably. Right, chat? Chat, tell me if you'd be all right with it.
I'll squint out. Bam, 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 yeah. One more invitation, please, Nick.
So, what I was going to say is, first topic of conversation that's
wait,
not
time
really
out.
A topic
Everyone
of conversation.
Has to wear gold and turquoise.
Well, how all about right. a timeout? Send me an ad, and then we can... There you go.
All right, I'll send you an ad.
I meant to say an advitation. Because you are advertising your game and inviting me to take part.
Ads, please.
But I was playing some Hollow Knight today.
Yeah.
God damn, that game's really good.
Yeah, it really is.
I'm a convert. I played one day of it, and I was like, yeah, I mean, this is good. Like, I got to Green Path, and I was like, yeah, I mean, like, this is good. I have a couple of issues with some things. I don't feel like I'm being powered up very quickly. Holy but shit. Now I
you
play
guys
today.
Know there is a downstairs.
Really yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, that's where you could get custom levels.
Why never we ever custom?
Because they're not very.
You gotta make
them. Yeah, that's the thing. It's like people, they don't zane in the proper fashion. They're always instead of like being like let the zaniness develop naturally. They're like, what if you started a level with a million saws and arrows on every
like
pixel?
Like we did that one episode we threw away.
So it doesn't just like have like the backgrounds and shit.
Nah.
Well, it lets you place down parts as your custom level on any of the levels that exist instead of letting you make a level from scratch.
Nick, did you add the custom rules?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. Nice. Let's do it.
Have you guys played Night in the Woods yet?
No.
No, I plan to soon though.
Same.
I watched someone play it though. It looks really good.
Yeah, I just
lost sale. Thanks a lot, Twitch.
It was good.
Well, you can sell them on Twitch now.
Not until spring 2017.
Actually, the other thing that I was
no,
gonna say is
why.
That, oh, sorry. I won't say it.
No, okay. Yes, please, Robert.
the other thing I was going to say is I made some mashed potatoes as a treat before the show.
Like just mashed potatoes.
As a treat.
You had like just a bowl. Potatoes. Well, how did you serve it? If you had just mashed potatoes, you're no longer needing a flat surface to put like a fillet of meat on. So did you put it in a bowl or did you put it on a plate?
It was on a plate.
You could boil and mash and put them in a stew.
Yeah, boil and mash.
Why not a bowl?
Well, I didn't have any bowls, so that's why.
This guy doesn't have any bowls.
I mean, I have bowls, but I have to.
I love bowls.
What do you smoke out of them?
This guy's asking all the right questions.
Marijuana. Marijuana is what he's talking about. Thanks, Mindy.
Was that be okay? But how did the rest of it go?
What, the mashed potatoes?
Yeah.
Oh, I was just gonna say, potatoes are a fucking miracle.
Yeah, they're absolutely delicious.
I had one potato, it was a giant plate of mashed potatoes, and it was super good, and it's like, I can make that into like 30 different things.
I didn't realize there was a stammer there.
Potatoes are just amazing.
I think Hollow Knight is better per capita than potatoes,
that's
but
ridiculous.
I agree they're both
I don't
good.
Think that's true at all.
You know how many millions then of years of evolution went into making the potato the perfect food?
Well, like, you know how many years of evolution it took to create Hollow Knight?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point. 100,000.
It's actually more because it's three people's worth.
Potatoes have been around a lot longer than people in the evolutionary record.
Are you sure about
well,
that?
You think
matter,
so? I was
complex.
Actually about to pose that question.
I'm
100% potatoes
confident.
Or humans have been around longer?
Oh, that bitch fucked
If I had me. To pick one to marry, I'd pick a human.
What if it was a really hot potato with a tight vagina?
Oh, I've seen a hot potato before. I know what you're talking about.
And I've fucked a potato before, so really, we have all the...
Wait, but really, though.
You ever smoked one?
You fucked a potato?
Have you ever smoked rice-a-roni out of a potato bong?
All the time. That's like my Saturdays.
It's pretty much the only way to do either of those things. Great song. Bay City Rollers.
So why did
More
like
the Bowl City Smokers. Oh, he made all! Yes! I just mousetrapped you fuckers.
Is that a ghost coin? That's a ghost
Why
coin.
Can't I get that coin?
It's a ghost coin.
It's a fan.
It's a ghost coin. Oh. Somebody's
no!
gonna ask a question,
oh,
right? I thought somebody was gonna ask a question a second ago.
Yeah, I was gonna say, when people microwave and fuck a watermelon, like, what's the deal with that? Why?
Well, the deal when I did it was 2-for-1 watermelons.
They're horny?
I mean, but it doesn't... Does it feel like a vagina?
I don't know.
Not. 5 months in a row, I bet you are the mashed potato with your hands. Didn't you, Robert? I did not.
What did you just say?
It was JJW's subscription message.
Hey, Rumble Muffin just bought me Night in the Woods. Thanks, man.
Oh, nice.
I was going to pick it up myself. I appreciate it.
Buy him Hitman so we can play it on the NLSS.
Can you play that on the NLSS?
I don't even
imagine
know.
Imagine us all starting the map at the same time and then trying to get eyes.
But doing war,
we predetermine who we're gonna kill in the map and how. And like it's a race.
And then race?
Yeah, I think it'd be a lot of fun.
That's somebody's life. We're making a game out of it?
Hell yeah!
Okay, right, by the way, side note, who is taking odds on humans versus potatoes?
Human.
For marriage.
Yes.
Or for...
And side, the other thing...
Oh, the evolutionary.
Which came first, yeah, humans or potatoes.
Well,
what,
I mean...
What are you guys thinking?
I'm gonna leave a little bit of extra dollop of sour cream in my potato.
Sour cream definitely came after humans.
Yeah, 100%.
See, chat's into it. Look at that.
Well, AG Shu says about 13,000 years ago, if botanists and scientists are right.
You just jumped into the.
No, the thing pushed me.
No, you fell in the. You got Mondo.
Good burgered. Yeah, exactly, dude.
13,000 years ago, but we're the ones that invented the system to keep track
of
those numbers.
That's exactly why I don't trust it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't trust carbon dating that way. I mean, why? No. You know, time is an abstract concept.
I mean, we invented carbon, so.
That's true as well, yeah. I mean, who says Jesus couldn't have walked with dinosaurs and, you know, rode them in against the Romans?
Just why like couldn't have Jesus Jeb. Been a dinosaur?
Mm-hmm. Old Jeb Thornton.
Them? You guys are good.
Yeah, we got Jeff Dunham a lot been a of time dinosaur. In this game. Like,
mm-hmm.
I mean, you're basically on Robert's level right now, so everybody's got to start somewhere.
It didn't translate into skill for me. I just... Stop caring about winning, and then you just do that, Josh. Stop caring about winning, and you'll be fine.
I've never cared.
Good. Like in general, or about winning?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think he made his point very clear there.
That's, you know, I hadn't considered that, but now that you say it, it makes all the more sense.
What if God was a dinosaur?
Maybe just a fossilized dinosaur, a carnivore, or herbivore, or possibly an omnivore.
So many vores.
He's alive? Oh, jeez.
Thank you.
I'm the only one that has a chance. Oh.
Brian, what?
Would you guys want to be a dinosaur if you could?
That's like a pretty intense question, right?
Depends how big.
Well, that was going to be my sub question. What kind of dinosaur would you be if your answer was yes?
I think I would want to be like a brontosaurus.
Is it for life?
Yeah.
So like, I can't be a human again.
Wait, we're missing a person.
Well, I mean, like, I think it's just I can't vote or exist.
Okay,
so.
Yeah.
Tell me about this dinosaur scenario.
All right, you got to be a dinosaur forever, but it's a dinosaur in the modern era, like right now. You could become a dinosaur, and you live as a dinosaur forever.
Pterodactyl.
They'd immediately shoot me and use me for parts and science.
No! They would actually just exploit you and like have you work in a circus or something.
They'd probably just extract your semen all the time, which sounds pretty fun.
Well,
yeah.
I don't know. You could just be like an alligator and...
Yeah, why can't I be an alligator extracting
You're
going
to choose to be an alligator? Instead of like a fucking T-Rex.
There's less chance of them like doing like experiments and shit on you, right?
Well, yeah, there's way more chance you get turned into jerky by fucking Jeb Bush's third cousin or something.
Yeah, or a handbag or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Or a hand job.
Fucking both.
Yeah.
Who died down there?
That was me. I'm not used to the floaty control. I've just been playing Hollow Knight and I'm not used to the floaty controls.
That's fair.
This.
Yeah. This doesn't have floaties.
But compared to Hollow Knight, it does. I will say.
What is a floaty? That sounds like a sexual thing.
It's a type of pool toy. Oh,
like, you'd be like, damn,
Josh,
dude, she got floaties.
Josh, put it on the barrel.
That means she's
don't
got
put
really
it, put it on the
big
black hole.
Upper arm muscles.
Yes.
All right.
It didn't push it. What
it's
the
pushing
fuck?
It. Look at it. Just pushed me into it. It's a swerving Murph.
I don't see it, though. On my screen, it's just...
It didn't push for me
It's
either.
Pushing for me.
Is
it also
really?
Didn't push for me.
Why is it pushing Raya?
Can't extract my semen if I'm under the water and make me a megalodon? Alright, that's reasonable. But they can probably still extract your semen. I mean, they gotta get whale cum somehow, right?
I think they do, yeah.
Right? They gotta get whale cum. How else are they going to know about the come of the whales?
Maybe they have one of those giant things like the horse fox
now
to
the,
get to come out of it.
Now the thing is moving.
Why do you think they're called sperm whales? I think I'd want to be a brontosaurus, dude.
Yeah?
I stand.
You have a big long neck. You're like a giraffe, but a dinosaur.
Here's the deal. You know, you're a T-Rex, you're in the fucking food chain. You're battling it out, right? I've seen King Kong. Big old monkey comes over, rips your jaw off.
Yeah.
I don't want any part of that.
Yeah, but you're basically a gazelle. What if somebody else chooses Tyrannosaurus? They're going to eat you anyway because you're big and weak, though.
I thought, like, Brontosaurus had, like, a... they had, like, a truce with the T-Rex. The Brontosaurus is like, hey, don't fuck with that guy. Because if you fuck with him, they're going to put their long necks...
You fuck with me!
When you can see the truce rock under the water.
I thought it was like a John Wick situation, where they sort of coexist, and you don't fuck with the Brontosaurus, or he'll, like, kill your whole family in the nightclub you own.
Thank you, Rumble Muffin. All right, Nick, so next Monday, we're playing Hitman.
That's probably a Triceratops.
You have to install
Hitman.
Did he
send me Hitman?
Yeah, he got it for you.
Oh, shit, I didn't see it come up.
See, now you have to play it.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, yeah, it's true. Now you have to play
it. We're playing Hitman now.
Yeah, play Hitman.
And now I gotta buy Undertale for Ronin.
Yeah, I'm not gonna play it, though.
Oh.
Yeah.
You should.
You don't need to.
Like, the
we
thing.
Can play it on the NLSS.
The thing that's been holding me back from Undertale is not the $10 asking price.
It's pretty fair, actually. It's good value for the
what
money.
What it would take from me in the process.
You should play Hollow Knight.
Hollow Knight's
got so much
value.
Yeah, I was thinking I'll probably, like, play Hollow Knight before Undertale, is my guess.
Yeah!
It's like a 30-hour game for 15 bucks.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Well, I mean, For Honor is like an infinity-hour game for 60 bucks.
Yeah, but is it,
but
though?
That game's stupid.
I don't know. I think it might be the best game made this year, actually.
But you... Well,
you know,
yeah,
something else came out this year, right?
Yeah, several things.
Witcher 3?
Hollow Knight?
Yeah, The Witcher 3 is definitely up there.
XCOM 2?
Oh, dude, that's
wait,
a big one.
Wait, 2017?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Super Mario Brothers 1.
Yeah, first. Yeah.
Wait, you guys are just blowing...
No,
John. No, the these all
Atari
came out.
ST We're serious pseudo-journalists, dude.
Oh, really?
Sad.
Oh.
You said sad like a buzzer.
Everyone's making fun of me for saying Four Honors Game of the Year, and then they're naming games that aren't even out yet. Who's the shill? I'm no shill, you're the shill.
I watched a little bit of Horizon Zero Dawn, and granted, I haven't played it yet, so grain of salt, but I was watching somebody play it, and I saw first bandit camp cleared, and I was just like, oh no.
The guys from Giant Bomb said it's not that bad.
Yeah.
Like, there's a few, and it kind of does like a lot of Far Cry things, but it's very far from Far Cry.
Can you make that sense a little bit more elegant, please?
Suck my dick.
Suck my dick.
It feels a lot more fleshed out, I guess, from how I understand what
how
they were
ironic,
talking.
Given that the flesh is made of robot parts.
Yeah.
In that game, the robot dinosaurs.
Yeah.
Robot.
Would you be a robot dinosaur or a regular dinosaur?
I'd rather be a robot dinosaur, 100%. Yeah.
Dude, that's like asking, would you rather be Mecha Godzilla or Godzilla? Well, actually, I'd probably rather be Godzilla now that I think
I'd rather be Robzilla.
I'd rather
be Grobzilla.
Go to the Bugzilla Lounge.
I want Rob to be like 60 foot.
Me too.
Terrorize the city.
Fuck yeah, I would absolutely.
Actually, you know what? Not even a city, like a small town.
Yeah.
Fuck it.
If you guys had, okay, like if you guys became Superman tomorrow. Okay.
I am Superman.
Yep.
Okay. Tomorrow.
So, if Josh, tomorrow. If you have a Tuesday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
If you have a Tuesday.
Sure. Get on with it.
Wait. Are you going to be a superhero or a supervillain? Like, would you go around saving people or would
you
be you like,
could play
all
Infamous.
Right, I just want you guys to know that I'm king of the earth now and there's really nothing you can do about it.
Do you
it.
Pick up the blue orbs or the red orbs, Josh?
I mean, I'd be like chaotic neutral.
I don't think I'd do it. I think I'd just live my life.
Or no, like. I wouldn't be lawful. I mean, I'd just be like, I would just like live my life. Be like, well, maybe I'll like rob this bank for like a day, and then I'll go live my life.
Yeah, well, that's really
that's,
the
that's
point
super villainous. That makes
you
a villain.
Yeah, that's like only like one time super villain. Like that's just dabbling.
Yeah, but I mean, it's still the.
You
know,
that,
it's still
you think
the
like that's a gateway drug to being a real villain?
Well, I think you were a real villain if you rob a bank when you have infinite power.
Yeah, right.
Just makes you kind of.
Yeah,
a
I would be a villain, I guess.
I think yeah, I would just live my life, dude, if I had superpowers. Nah, people would be like, oh, save my kid.
Ended up.
You know, gotta catch a superhero on the run, I think is how you become supervillain number one.
Dude, what? Here's the thing. What I got superpowers. What is it? Just because I'm, like, naturally good at basketball doesn't mean I have to be in the NBA. Just because I'm, you know, naturally good at math doesn't mean I have to be, like, a chartered accountant or something. Why is it just because I've got heat vision and the ability to fly, all of a sudden I gotta choose between two career paths? What if I want to be an actuary?
I mean, you could probably make a decent living just, like, doing something cool.
Yeah, but why would
I think you should pile drive one empty plane just to get it into people's heads that this is what you're capable of.
Yeah.
Well, just have someone record it, too.
Can we all just, like, thank you for, like, using pile drive?
Being a friend.
Yeah, down this road and back again. But, like, then here's the thing. If you ever save anybody's cat from a tree,
yeah,
all of a sudden you got to save everybody's cat, right? Otherwise, they're gonna resent you. What I want is that, like, if I work, like, I'm an, you know, an insurance adjuster or something like that, right? And somebody comes and like, hey, Superman, like, I know this is like over the line, but like, I've been having some problems this week. Is it possible that you could like use your heat vision to remove this mole off of my neck?
Yeah,
I'd be like, you know what, Ron? I actually can't, okay? And you cross the line just by asking. And I don't know if we can ever return.
What if I was like, hey, Superman, I've been having some problems in the bedroom and I need you to fuck my wife like the best fucking ever so she respects me again?
Well, that's the question, right? So can Superman come inside of Lois?
What do you mean?
I don't know.
Because like his cum might be like superpowered or something.
Yeah, it might just like be a shotgun out of her spine. Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Why does it, like when he breathes, it's not like his speech knocks people over unless he wants it to.
Well, yeah.
It's not like Clark Kent says hello and like blows down a fucking city block, right?
Okay, well then secondary question, because I'm sure
a secondary question.
Fucking kidding me. Secondary question. See, he probably had to learn how to do that so he didn't like, you know, freeze his mother when he breathed.
Hancock.
Maybe? I don't know.
I mean, probably. He has to train to do that, right? So, like, who was the first poor lady that got murdered by Superman's cum before, you know, and he had to cover up the body?
No, he just disintegrated the body. He didn't have to cover it up.
What did he cover the body with?
Yeah. He could have also frozen the body and shattered it.
Mm, yeah.
Yeah, that would have been a good
idea. He could have just picked her up and then thrown her into space.
Yeah, forgot. He has the reach of space.
When we get, like, micro rocket ships that everybody can 3D print, it's going to be way easier to get away with murder, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be like, oh, we found a body.
What?
Ooh. We found a body in space. Carbon dating says that they were murdered, like, 11,000 years ago and then jettisoned to Alpha Centauri. Like, well, the guy who's definitely, like, it's her boyfriend that murdered her, and he's been dead for 100 centuries. So, posthumously, that guy's kind of a dick, but
yeah.
Can't really do too much about it now.
Why did... What? Oh, it was the fire.
Flower.
Yeah, the flower hydrant.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. I was watching an Elon Musk video where he was talking about shooting garbage to the sun. To burn it.
We should.
Dope, dude. I see no negatives.
Like, I don't know why we haven't done that.
I think the problem right now is that, yeah, it costs like $100,000 a kilogram.
Yeah, mainly. Yeah.
Hashtag worth it.
Well, what if we put them in volcanoes, though? Why wouldn't that work?
There's gotta be a reason that's not smart, right?
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Otherwise, they would have done it by now.
I don't know any reason that wouldn't work in my
mind.
Why
don't we just
so
well, okay, wait, wait, wait.
Well,
what if you...
matter. It's not like matter goes away.
Right,
so,
yeah.
Like, eventually you're just gonna
forms.
Fill it up.
Yeah, if you... Oh, dude, and you would not want a volcano full of garbage erupting.
Volcano!
Erupting, like, baby diapers and syringes, like...
that are also on fire.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be good.
Rob, you'd be in paradise. The ultimate trash panda paradise.
That's true, yeah. It'd be perfect for raccoons.
It would melt the needles, though.
Apparently it's the toxic fumes that would poison us all.
That makes sense. Yeah, that also makes sense. Well, I'm glad we figured that out.
What if you just put a cap on the volcano after you put the trash in there?
You know,
yeah, cover it up.
Yeah, dude. An impermeable membrane that the gas can't get out of, and then you just, you know, push it off to the side when you got more garbage to go in.
What yeah. if you
you dig a hole to the earth's core,
make a rubber cap over it.
You put all the trash in it, and then you fill it back up.
You make a rubber cap over it, you let the gas fill it like a balloon, and you let the balloon rise off it into space.
There you go, yeah. Mm, yeah. Just like a balloon.
Yeah. Balloon.
CG.
You got it. Yeah. That's a good idea. It fills up a balloon full of gas, and then you just let it float out of the atmosphere.
Off the bottom, and it just goes away.
In theory, couldn't we, if we made a space elevator, and we applied enough thrust, you probably wouldn't need a lot of thrust to make a line of garbage constantly moving towards the sun, right?
Like Superman fucking your wife, a lot of thrust.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
It really does mean that we fucked ourselves for first contact, though. Because, like, if aliens come by now, they'll probably be like, hey, you know, this Earth is relatively unmolested. I mean, as far as, like, spacefaring species go, it could be worse, right? And then if they come and we're surrounded by garbage that is just continuously being shot into orbit, then we'd be like, maybe we'll just leave that planet behind.
Kettle Root, I am for ketchup on eggs.
Sure, why not?
I am not. That's fine. Not.
But back to the garbage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's gotta be an easy way to get rid of it, right?
Yeah, dude. I mean, I've been trying to, like, make less actively. But I was like, destroyed it instead?
Yeah, I just make more.
Do you though?
Yeah.
I don't like that.
Trash. Make extra garbage, yeah.
I look at people, I give them a look. If they're at the grocery store and they're like, do you need bags? And they're like, yeah, I'll take 4 bags. I'm like, all right. Guess somebody doesn't think they're going to be living too much longer. fuck the next generation, I suppose.
Why don't we just make a plastic mountain, like George Carlin said?
And then melt it.
Fill it with trash and then melt it down.
Absolutely, yeah. See, I think a fundamental issue that we're running into commonly here in these logical riddles is that...
United States, yes.
Right.
That's a good band.
We seem to be under the impression that matter goes away.
Oh.
It does.
As a matter of fact, in a few seconds...
You won't even be matter.
Right.
Be matter. So
when you burn coal, the coal doesn't go away.
Oh man, I fucking love coal.
The coal it becomes gaseous.
Yeah.
Gaseous coal.
And it goes away as gas.
The best boxer of all time. Exactly.
Gaseous coal.
Well, it's not gaseous coal.
You burn the coal, and then there's no more coal because it's gas.
Yeah. And then now you're just left with coal.
My product that I'm concerned with is not coal gas.
I'm so stupid.
You can have all that you want.
Ryan, that was amazing!
Thanks, buddy. Lost levels.
I'm joking, I understand the gas. Fuck off.
What if we just got the Earth really high?
That does
sound like a good solution.
Fucking...
Like in the air.
Yeah.
Yeah, just like we'll just like lift it up.
Global warming. What about global smarking?
What about global matter?
Wait, smark is a global emote at least.
Global smarking.
Oh no!
Did we talk about this on the LSS?
The rat! Stupid trash rat.
Were we talking about on the LSS or on Factorio where we were talking about how Bear was wrong about s'mores being the best Pop-Tart flavor?
Yeah, that was in Factorio, but I do, I agree with you, dude, that it's strawberry.
It's definitely s'mores. Strawberry. You think it's s'mores? It's too chocolate. It's too much chocolate. Yeah,
absolutely too much
That's
chocolate.
That's your problem. It's good.
I didn't, like, I like it. I'm fine with it, but I ate too much of it as a small boy.
Wait, I can't. All right, what am I going to do? I don't know.
Reese's Cup cereal is still good, too.
No.
Yeah, I do like Reese's.
You have to, like, preferably on, like, your 26th birthday or something, but, you know, I'll allow it is what I'm saying here. You gotta swear off those child cereals, man.
Why?
Yeah. Honey Bunches of Oats.
They passed you by, dude.
I also eat Raisin Bran Crunch, which is the opposite of a child cereal.
That's not a child, so that's gross. Not the opposite. The Crunch
Raisin Bran Crunch.
The Crunch adds a little more joy than should be in an adult cereal.
But really, Raisin Bran Crunch is too childish.
Yeah, it's got crunch.
I feel bad for your
As enemies. Soon as there's an onomatopoeia in a cereal name, it's not for adults. If a cereal's called, like, chocolatey yum-yums, you can't eat it if you're over the age of 25.
Wait, well, yum-yum isn't an onomatopoeia, is it?
Yeah, because when you eat something that's good, you go yum-yum-yum-yum-yum.
Yeah, but you say that because, like, that's... Right?
It's involuntary.
What came first, the yum or, like,
God was right, I don't know if that's an onomatopoeia or not.
That's an onomatopoeia.
Crunch is also, I mean, I guess it is.
Yeah, when you bite into something that's crunchy, it goes crunch.
I guess, but like, is that, okay, I actually want a chicken before the egg that. Did the word crunch come before the onomatopoeia or after?
The onomatopoeia.
Yeah. Because it crunches a descriptor.
I don't think so.
I did.
It's not like pow or bang.
Or biff.
Yeah. Biff. Biff Tanner.
Turk. You ever just punch somebody and their face just went Turk?
All the time, dude.
Rob, what did you do that for?
I don't know. Make the path that I'm about to go on hard.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah. Oh, there's a hay bale. That's nice.
Yeah. I put that there.
According to NL, Nesquik is an adult cereal? I don't think so. It's chocolate-based.
Yep. So any chocolate-based cereal is bad?
How much chocolate are you eating?
Any chocolate-based cereal is bad?
If you wanted me to keep going, give
Josh,
me more
what
that
cereal thing. Do you eat?
Honey Bunches of Oats.
Hell
the
yeah.
Generic kind.
Acceptable.
From the store.
What is it? What's it called?
I don't know.
Like it's called like
Oat Cluster.
Yeah, exactly. I love it, dude. It's like, there's Rice Krispies, and then the AAA brand, or the, I guess the AA brand, is called Crispy Rice.
Oh, God damn it!
It's like, no matter which orientation of the words, it still describes it completely perfectly.
Why should adults never feel joy?
I just think, like, you I still think you just shouldn't make it that easy on yourself.
All right. Wait, what kind of what cereal
exactly
are you eating?
How
cardboard and glass
myself.
Cereal O's?
I haven't been eating cereal lately. I've been having toast with peanut butter.
Thank you.
That sounds like a lot of joy to me.
Wait, you get that peanut butter? That's filled with sugar.
No, it's natural peanut butter.
They still
is all
peanut there's exactly no shit. It's just peanuts stuff. In it.
Well, there's not just peanuts.
It's just you look at the back ingredients, peanuts.
No, there's got to be like some.
They put oil or something.
It's your ingredients, right? Peanuts.
Peanuts in your mouth.
Adults should not have any fun. Proceeds to make YouTube Let's Play channel.
Who says I'm having a good time?
Oh.
Yeah, have you met us?
No, I haven't.
Gotta hang
Who
out with
you?
These fuckers.
You don't want to.
No.
Oh, peanuts have natural oil. Okay. Well, that food has carbon in it.
I'm fucked. Well,
natural carbon, though?
Yeah, is it perfluorocarbons?
Cat, I absolutely hope not.
Stupid.
Kill me.
Why do you shit on cereal? You love peanut butter? I don't shit on
Ew,
cereal.
Ew, you're shitting on your cereal now?
Yeah, that's pretty gross.
Where do you think
that
the peanut butter comes from?
Is that what adults do?
gave me some two girls, one cup flashbacks, to be honest with you.
Dude, I love peanut butter.
I thought
you were
going to
say, I love two girls, one cup.
It really sounded like that's where that was going.
But for real, though, peanut butter is, like, the dopest.
Again, it really seemed like you were going to be like, for real, though,
for
two
real,
girls,
though,
one cup.
Just peanut butter shitting into the air.
Toast is really good.
Just gets me.
Dude, peanut butter.
Hard as a rock.
Peanut butter on breakfast is really good.
Yeah.
I've had peanut butter in my eggs before.
Oh, I don't like that.
Yeah, that sounds real gross.
You win some, you lose some.
I've been having a bagel with butter for the past.
Oh fuck!
Yeah, what the breakfast. Fuck is this hellscape?
I'm proud of you, Robert.
I just put butter on potato chips and then pour milk on them. Am I an adult yet?
This guy, he's acting like it's a joke, but he's dipping his Pringles in cottage cheese.
Wait,
yeah,
are you really?
Yeah.
Ew. Oh god, do you also eat prunes for dinner, grandma?
What?
This cottage cheese is an old person food.
Oh.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's an old person food or like a, you know, I'm trying to get abs food.
Yeah.
Why is it an old person food?
Have you ever seen it? It's gross.
It looks like old people's diarrhea.
Cunts!
Oh god!
You survived up there in the
Why would it be white?
It's probably some of the best play I've ever done in my entire life.
Same reason their hair turns white. Their poop turns white too. You never look at old people poop?
Wait, you never look at old people poop?
Don't lie to me. Does old people
is their stomach white? A furnace and it turns it into ash?
Yeah, absolutely. They just shit ash out of their butt. I know.
Well, pick wisely.
I pick Wesley. Snipes.
Snipes? Is he still in jail?
No, he got out. He was in the Expendables 3?
6.
9?
Why isn't he doing more stuff now?
Maybe he doesn't want to deal with your bullshit, honestly. You ever try to get hired as an ex-con?
I try to get high as an ex-con.
Hell yeah,
Boomerang in my text, spaghetti and cream cheese is legit.
Wait, why are we all on Iceberg?
Spaghetti and cream cheese?
In cream cheese or with cream?
And.
That sounds tasty. I would eat that.
Spaghetti and cream cheese.
I don't like that.
I would totally eat that.
I mean...
But I would also eat, like, all the disgusting things that you guys say that is disgusting. So, I guess...
Wait, what is this?
What are you doing here?
I don't know. I'm just gonna die. If you make it into, like, a sauce, I can see it.
We had some good thinking going there.
Oops, white. Like, but you capitalized the W in white, so, like, what does that mean?
White.
It's the last name.
You guys like smoked salmon cream cheese?
Yes.
It's amazing.
It's acceptable.
Acceptable? You're insane.
Adults should not have any fun, Rob.
Cream cheese is a very adult food.
Yeah, probably.
I think it's more of a fun food because you have it on ants on a log.
No.
I don't... Wait, ants on a log?
That's cheese whiz or peanut butter.
You can have peanut butter or cream cheese.
No, if it's cream cheese...
You can.
And, no, because that's white. It's like ants on a white.
I guess it could be a birch.
Yeah, ants on... It's a birch log.
Yeah. Choke. Ants on a white.
I've never had ants on a log.
Yeah, it's like
that was a good one.
Well, it's like peanut butter, raisins, and celery, right?
Yeah.
Or cream cheese.
Gross.
Yeah, no, I don't. I actually don't understand the idea of it as a food. That's like one of those foods from like the 60s that we never got rid of.
Yeah.
Tomato aspic as well.
Tomato aspic?
I get some tomato aspics.
It's
cold salad jelly stuff.
Dude, I don't think there's any chance.
No, just jump.
Something like this. Something like this. Yeah, you're not going to be able to make it, but if you go like, right,
yeah, you got it.
Ants on a log sans the ants is pretty good. The amount of explanation that requires, why don't you just say fucking celery?
Well, it's one of those things that's like... I'm noticing now, everybody's like, that's a food for kids. That's a food for kids. How quickly the discourse changes. Apparently there are children's foods, but I do agree that it's a food exclusively for kids that you're like, hey, I want you to eat celery, but celery's not fun. So
and Pringles right and cream cheese, Pringles and cottage cheese. You mind flooded me somehow.
Pringles and cheese cream.
It's specifically an adult or old person food.
Ah, cock! Right, fall down now.
No, I gotta beat the level. No, I earned it, dude.
Right,
get the coin. Go get the coin.
I don't think that coin's getting
Don't do it, that as adult is semen. Don't diet shame.
You fucking no. No, I was just kidding.
I wasn't kidding. You get that coin. You man the fuck up and you get that coin, boy.
Oh fuck.
Ooh, it's totally gettable actually though.
It's totally faux gettable.
Oh!
Oh, that thing pushed me.
Celery
yeah,
is trash.
Celery is fine.
It's trash. It's like the worst vegetable that exists.
It's actually
ridiculous. I love celery.
It's one of the best raw vegetables for sure.
I agree. I like celery.
It's one of the best raw vegetables for sure.
I always try to put it in macaroni salad. Fuck that shit. I don't want it.
You should put it in stews. How do you like celery in stews?
You need it. It's my celery. It's part of a mirepoix. If you're not having your stews with a mirepoix, I'm not eating any of your stews.
God, what the hell is
you couldn't handle my stews?
Oh, god damn it.
All vegetables are just water. Oh, doctors hate him. This guy figured out the secret.
He tastes like dirty.
Well, that's if you don't clean it. You do have to clean it, you know, because it gets all dirt in the stalks.
I don't like cleaning vegetables.
You know what? Me neither, dude.
They're there. Someone's had to have cleaned them along the way.
Charlie, come on, man.
Yeah, why aren't they cleaning my potatoes for me? Why do I always have to clean off the potatoes? You know what I'm saying?
I never clean potatoes.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't.
I just chop those up and throw them in the skillet. It's gonna cook out the things that makes it bad anyways, right?
Well, I mean, it's more about like not eating a big clump of dirt.
Yeah, mainly, yeah.
Well, wouldn't I see the dirt?
Well, I don't know. You're not looking at it that hard.
And
what are you talking about?
You said you just cut it up and throw it in the skillet.
Who's chopping without looking?
Dude, you see the dirt bigger. Though. That's why the potato, like all the
I've
dark
seen
brown
dirt
spots
before, like outside, but not ever like on my potato unless I'm in a barn.
Are you having an Idaho potato?
You know, potatoes come out of dirt.
Yeah, but like after they reach the Josh house, there's no more dirt.
You must have some clean ass fucking.
I mean, I'll clean some vegetables if I'm like feeling like it. But
or if somebody's
not, like,
watching me.
I just don't like
raspberries.
No,
I
don't
eat
a lot of raspberries.
Just eat them straight out of the fucking container.
Yeah, I don't know.
You know,
I don't know, man. There's all those little hairs on them. It makes me paranoid that there's a spider in one of them. So I just gotta keep
potatoes?
Washing them.
Huh.
No, in the raspberries.
Oh.
They're full of little hairs.
Josh,
full,
your
like,
potatoes.
Legs.
See, Josh doesn't know what dirt looks like. I don't know, man.
My mom didn't want to eat broccoli anymore after someone told her that.
Like when you wash, like, is it just like running it under like water and that's it? Like that's...
Yeah, pretty much. You don't have to rinse it. You just rinse it, really. You don't have to be super hardcore about washing a potato.
Oh. I scour them for hours.
Do you?
No.
Oh. You just rinse them underwater. You
get
out
most
of the dirt.
Rinse them underwater, though.
So like, yeah, you just like rinse it, right?
Pretty much.
Yeah. You
give it a little rinse.
I've
and scrub.
Done that before.
So you don't get. This is the first time we've completed the level.
I've done it.
Yeah, so you don't get the manure and, you know, fertile soil on your food.
Well, you just gotta make sure there's no spiders in there, that's all.
There's definitely no spiders in your potatoes.
You don't know. Spiders know what they're doing with this.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
They've had years to perfect their technique.
I hadn't considered that.
You were having premarital sex.
Yo, you gotta wash your rice. If you're not washing your rice, you're actually missing out.
Do you have to, like, wash Uncle Ben's rice?
I don't even know if that's a food.
I don't think so, because that comes in a package with, like, flavorings and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Do you wash your ramen?
Oh, no, my mom thought there were ants in broccoli.
You have to wash the rice.
Because you gotta get as much of the starch out as possible. It makes for a better rice product in the end.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Unless it's jasmine rice, that's correct.
Yeah.
It's not like
jasmine
you're
loves starch.
You're not washing it to get the dirt out. You're washing it to get the starch out.
That's like when you make french fries. You gotta put
exactly.
them in the bowl and get the starch out of the potatoes so that they crisp up better.
Is that what you do?
That's what mouth does.
Right, who's the asshole with the bows and arrows over here?
It's really hard to say.
Yeah, I don't know who put that there.
What? On my thing, you'd be dead.
Do you wash your mashed potatoes or just your whole potatoes?
Well, you don't wash potatoes after they're mashed. Wash them with some freaking butter and garlic.
Wash them down my
I mean,
throat
again,
with saliva.
You're gonna hate this, but this is why I'm also like, I'm not so big on the food poisoning thing. Like before I met, you know,
really
that old trend.
That one, huh?
You really don't believe in food poisoning.
It's not that I don't believe in it. I just think a lot of times people, you know, make big mistakes and then they blame it on food poisoning, but it's not food's fault. Because like I've never, until I met Kate, I like very rarely washed produce. And never
so
gotten food
me.
Poisoning. Yeah, pretty much correct.
Yeah, and I never get food poisoning.
Yeah, but just because you don't get it doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
I'm not suggesting it doesn't exist, just that it's misdiagnosed.
I'm not existing. I'm just telling you that I'm good. I'm good to go. I'm Crunchwrap Supreme.
When you do get food poisoning,
what do you mean,
it's
when?
Hell. Well, I had food poisoning
it's
like 2 weeks
ago. It's a win.
I don't think it's a win.
The worst I felt.
I think I would have had it by now if I was going to get it.
I promise you're going to get food poisoning at one point.
You're saying you developed a tolerance to it.
I'm not saying I've developed a tolerance. I'm just saying I think it's rarer than people give it credit for.
No, I mean, I just put a curse on you. You're going to get food poisoning.
Yeah, fucking do it. I'd never let on that I would have it. I would rather shit myself on the show than admit having food poisoning at this point. There's no coming back. I can't get food poisoning. It's the end of my credibility.
How do we get up?
Be career suicide.
What is this bullshit? Who devised this?
I think you can make it through that, yeah, the little one tile.
Oh, yeah, you gonna make it through that one tile?
Oh, wait, no, Brad,
you went through the hole.
Yeah.
You cheater. Kill yourself.
Jesus.
Not like God. That way, but like in the game sphere. Brad, I'm sorry.
I didn't mean that.
I don't take any offense to that. Have you seen what Chance says about me?
Yeah, that's a good point.
I don't know.
He's proven it's gettable.
I don't read chat. you gotta be careful with that one. That'll get you every time. Does NL think food poisoning is some disease?
What are you talking? It is a disease.
It's contracted through bacteria, yeah.
Well, isn't it a virus?
Isn't it a cluster of viruses and bacterias and parasites and whatnots?
I don't know. I don't think it has anything to do with viruses. Probably. But maybe it does. You ever think about
lettuce
that?
Lettuce is gonna be a Crunchwrap with spiders if he doesn't wash. I hate that sentence.
Straight up, if any spiders have, gotten eaten by me as a result of existing in my lettuce, straight up, it's their loss. Like,
yeah.
I didn't even notice.
The average human eats 52 spiders per night while they sleep.
Remember, don't worry.
You know what?
Gotta watch out for
that
this.
That seems low.
You know, camel spiders, they're like really big, right?
Yeah, the size of camels.
Yeah.
That's why they call them that.
I don't know if that's true.
I thought they took over the camel's body and then lived in its hump.
Yeah, I don't think any of that is true. But either way, my
point is... Oh, the camera! The camera didn't follow me!
Point is, if you boil a camel spider, you think it would taste good with butter?
Josh, NL is lining straight up. In an Isaac episode, he talked about a ramen place that gave him food poisoning.
No, not food poisoning. Oh, I say it gave me diarrhea.
That wasn't food poisoning. That was, he just got sick.
No, it was diarrhea like 30 minutes after finishing the meal. That was just like some kind of allergy to something that they used to cook that was like irritating
me. That was
it. That's not food
poisoning. That might just be minor food poisoning.
You can't possibly get food poisoning in a half hour. Doesn't make any damn sense.
I think you're crying.
It's a trap.
I just went in and came out the other end.
Yeah, I've done that before.
Campbell spiders, they hang out in soup. Oh, God. Imagine you lift the tin on
that
a soup can and just a spider coming out at you.
Chat, you guys are so up your own asses.
That's
you have
hell.
No idea. Get yeah, there we go. NL is right. Thank you. The one doctor in chat agrees with me.
How do you know he's a doctor? Does he have doctor in the name?
Oh,
he DM'd.
I'm allergic to peanuts. I just ate a bunch of peanut butter. I got food poisoning. It's not food poisoning.
Well,
you got poisoned by food, but that's not food poisoning.
Technically, he did get poisoned by food.
No, so if I put cyanide in like a milkshake, that's food poisoning. Wow, looks like it's lethal food poisoning. Just another fatal food poisoning here. Open
well,
and shut case, Lou.
Let me ask you a separate question then. Do they put any rats in rat poison? I think not.
What probably. In the world is that supposed to prove?
Oh, he's right.
Right?
He's got
exactly.
You roasted.
Mm-hmm.
Dead to rights.
Told ya.
You guys remember that game called
Dead to
Rights?
Yeah.
You roll behind things and shoot at them.
Honestly,
Dead to Rights Extreme Beach
Volleyball. Probably the best game of 2017 so far.
Dead to Rights.
Oh, I guess I've been knocked off by the camera again.
Are you farting on me?
Brad, did he die?
I guess I've died.
You got 0 points.
Oh, well, there you go.
Make one. He's the ultimate chameleon. Nice. Oh, what's next?
We're gonna play Sonic and All Stars Racing Transformed.
All Transformed Racing Stars.
You guys are going down a slippery slope. This guy's like, should I believe the one person in the call or the 6,500 people in chat? Have you ever seen the Twitch chat before?
You know what chat is like made of?
Chat is just made of anarchy. I'm not saying I'm necessarily right. I'm just saying, why don't you just look it up on the internet? Minimum incubation time for food poisoning. Okay. For Clostridium perfringens, 8 to 22 hours. For you need to come inside and check low, relax yourself and let the coolie love flow. Camp Lobacter, 2 to 7 days. Check this shit out.
I've never low-backed anybody. That sounds fun.
Here, give me some more minimum incubation times.
Hold on. AG Shu in my chat says, tell NL that I'm a nursing student and food poisoning is caused by everything from a simple bacteria to a serious parasite and can have symptoms ranging from diarrhea to vomiting to life-threatening complications.
Right. Yeah. No, right. I mean, thanks, Wikipedia.
All right. What does that mean, though, Rob?
Like, if you eat 20 banana spiders in the middle of your soup,
You're gonna have banana virus.
West banana virus.
West Vile.
West Vile banana virus.
Yeah.
You're gonna have West Nile banana virus.
Here's one. Vibrio parahemolytis. 4 to 30 hours. And Staphylococcus aureus. 1 to 6 hours. There you go. Raw meat and poultry, cheese, cream, unpasteurized milk, and processed meat. There is one type of food poisoning that gives you an incubation period of 1 to 6 hours, and it causes nausea, vomiting, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea, but it lasts for 1 to 3 days. I feel like it would say 1 to 2 upset shits.
Stomach, all right. Diarrhea. All
right. 1 to 2 shits? You think it'd say that?
Once I took a shit, I was fine.
Question, Ryan, though. Then if it wasn't food poisoning or from the food, where'd you get the diarrhea?
No, I think it was just that there's an ingredient in the food that is a mild irritant to my stomach or my GI tract somewhere, and it's like, hey, dude, you gotta take a shit.
Poop. No, but diarrhea is like, not only do you have to take a shit, it's like, instead of making solid poop, we're just gonna give you some poop.
Well, I didn't bring a stool sample to the doctor and go check it out. I just shit this out here.
I mean, you should've.
I did.
Hey, I'm trying to settle a bet on the internet, doc.
On the NLSF, doc.
Yeah, on the NLSF.
Shoot some at the fridge and see what sticks.
That's how you know it's done. When your diarrhea is
your
done.
Your poop scoop's done.
Hey, invite me to this Sonic game.
Do we have, like, a lot of the maps or just, like, the same
story? We have more now, I think.
We have more.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
I invited you guys. I invited all of you.
You invited me?
Yeah.
Thanks,
Rob. You invited me? Also, yeah, I bought DLC for this, so now I have the Shenmue arcade cabinet.
Do you have any other maps?
And I also have Metal Sonic.
Oh, okay.
Nice. I might have other maps, but I can't give them to you because you didn't buy the DLC.
I'm inviting my friend Corey as a seat filler because he said he would throw some dailies if I gave him a spot on the on the match.
Nice. What? Nice. Well, tell me whenever we're ready to start. Did anybody say anything in the analysis chat about getting anybody else? Are we doing that or
get
no?
Bear?
Yeah. Rainbow, this is Bear.
Get Rainbow Bear.
Get Rainbow Bear. Rainbow Bear. Rainbow Bear. Rainbow Bear. Rainbow Bear. Rainbow Bear. my fellow Americans, I have a rainbow bear.
Hey, that's pretty good, Obama.
Yeah, thanks. I figure, you know, now's the time to be a good Obama.
Yeah.
The 8 years before, he's not going to be relevant then.
Hey.
Our fellow Americans.
Hey, I got him.
Oh, hey, rainbow bear.
Rainbow bear.
Cap of Pride. Bear Taffy.
Cap of Pride.
Bear Taffy.
Hello.
Hey, it's Austin.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Hey, Austin. Happy birthday, Bear.
Rainbow Bear?
Rainbow Bear.
Happy birthday, Rob.
Thanks, man.
Happy birthday, Rainbow Bear.
Happy Cap of Pride, Rainbow Cappy Pride.
Is it actually your birthday, Bear Tappy?
No, it's not my birthday.
Why did you say that? We could have had a thing.
We did that with PlayerUno for like 3 years.
And it's still funny.
Yeah, it's not. It hasn't stopped.
It's hilarious.
I gotta beat this game up.
Wait, what does license mean?
Gotta go to school. Yeah, play by the rules.
Gotta go fast.
Rab, you're ranked C. I'm also ranked C.
Rainbow Rare.
Nick
is
ranked
C. Need
a
bear and an Austin in here.
I'm I invited him.
Austin's this guy's ranked A.
Austin,
you
ever had
shit?
Food poisoning?
Yeah, I talked about it on the show.
You ever eaten?
Yeah, but when
pepper?
We were listening, did you talk about it?
Yeah, you were there too, Josh.
Mm. You missed the vital part of that Josh question, which is when he was listening. which is
seldom.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Rainbow Bear.
Next to never.
Rainbow Bear.
Is that a character in this game, Rainbow Bear?
Rainbow, this is Bear.
Oh, yeah, Rainbow. I like that code name.
Rainbow calling Bear Taffy. We've got a Houston in our problem.
You can.
My fellow like,
Rainbow Bear.
You got a Houston in our problem. Like, the problem is, like, the Earth, and, like, Houston is just, like, on it.
Oh, damn, it's not recognizing my controller.
Why is Corey rank A?
Who's Corey?
Why is Corey in the house?
He's a busta.
We should play that on the house.
Corey was my drummer in my first band.
Was he?
Whoa. Was he a good drummer?
Corey's a race car driver. He drums so goddamn fast.
Never did band the checker flying, but he sure the hell did last.
Can you call paper plates dishes?
Yes.
All right. Play one without me. I gotta figure out what's going on.
Play with your mouse.
Play with your mouse keyboard.
You can play with your mouse keyboard?
Play with
your mouse.
I mean,
I am playing with the mouse keyboard.
Hey, Austin, now that you're here, I want to roast you and Robert.
Both of us?
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
What's up with the paper plates?
I don't want to accept this.
Yeah, what's the roast?
What's up with the paper plates?
Oh. What's wrong with paper plates? Hold on.
Rob, there's a lot wrong with paper plates. It's wasteful.
Austin, we're being jointly roasted here.
I want to make sure we're on a real level.
We have to have a united front.
Before we start, we got to be real or no one's
He's trying to eliminate all the weak points so that you only have strong ones left.
If you counter the argument, it's hard for me to, you know, come over the top. That's fair.
Right.
Side note, speaking of start, can I press that button? Or no?
Yeah.
I'm going to do mouse and keyboard, I guess. I don't know how well this is going to go.
Let's try it out.
So
I'll try it out, yeah.
Generally yes, or...
Hit the button.
What is Luke doing
in here?
How did he get here?
You gotta hang out.
Nothing wrong with that.
I told him we should hang out.
Oh, I don't have any things to spend.
Here's the thing about paper plates. You don't gotta wash them.
Oh, wow, that's a new one. Never heard of that one before.
Wait, you don't have to wash them?
You can wash them,
though. Wrong this entire
You can wash them, but it would be a mistake because they're made of paper.
Rainbow Bear.
I just hate the fucking dishes, man.
Yeah, exactly.
Let me ask you something. Let me ask you something.
They're fine.
What's the point of a plate?
To eat food off of.
Food.
Right.
It's like a human trough.
Does anyone know how to go?
Oh, I don't know how to go on the keyboard.
Probably left mouse button?
Why use a paper plate? Why not just eat off of your desk?
Because then you'd have to clean it up.
No, you just use a paper towel.
But that's not how cleaning works.
Hot food, you can't carry it in your hands.
What are you talking about? Just put the pot on your desk.
Is there a hot button?
Yeah, there's
nothing
a hot
works.
Hop button. Like in Mario Kart where you hop?
I don't think so.
If I'm going to be on a real level, you need to be on a real level.
Okay,
too,
fair enough. I think using paper plates is wasteful and contributes to a state of arrested development on becoming of a man in his early to mid-20s.
Yeah, but, like, who cares, though?
Is there a Mario Kart thing where you can...
Rob! Wait, Josh!
Just answer my damn question!
I don't know if there's a hop button. Nobody plays Mario Kart and goes, what's hop?
I don't think there's a hop button, though.
Is there a way to go around corners fast? Or like?
Yeah, you use the brake.
The brake?
Yeah, the same way you do with freaking Mario Kart.
No one presses the brake to do it in Mario Kart. You press the
brake
hop button.
Nobody uses
hop.
I think you press the hop button.
You totally press the hop button.
You do.
You're a hopper.
What the fuck is the hop?
Just press L, Josh.
It's L. Right.
It's after you hop, you can turn sideways.
It's L plus counter steer.
Get out of here, you weirdo.
Josh, you get out of here.
Look, now we got passed.
Oh, I'm about to lap Bear.
Yeah, and whose fault is that, Rob?
Josh. Wait, what?
Your fault.
Yeah, I guess it's my fault that I lap Bear. You're right.
Matt, what are you doing? You're freaking out.
No way.
That's bad kitties. Just kidding, you're cute.
You gotta get some normal plates, man.
I have them. I don't want to do the dishes.
Yeah, I mean, I've got them too. I also just don't want to do the dishes.
Like, that's literally the only reason.
If you're not doing the dishes, the dishes are doing you.
Is there a secret?
My God. Josh, just race your freaking car, dude.
When I cook,
yeah,
I clean while I cook.
Well, so what does that mean? You throw the paper plate in the garbage before the food's even made?
No, the point is when I'm done with my dishes when the food is done being made, pretty much. Because then I just clean the pan. But if I add another step, then I have to go back and clean afterwards so I have the paper plates because I just throw the paper plate.
Here's an idea. Empty the pot directly into the trash and eat out of the trash.
That would work too.
I clean while I cook. So there's like less dishes. And since like if you're cooking, then you're fucking cleaning up like right when you're doing it. You have to wait when you're cooking. So just clean all your shit like whilst you're doing it.
I just cook it in my mouth.
As well.
Just right on in there.
Well, yeah, that's what you do with sandwiches.
You get a butane torch and you just fucking roast that shit.
That's my tongue surface.
No, I agree. That's how I consume pasta is I just put a handful of flour and raw eggs in my mouth.
Why am I the uncivilized one for using a plate?
You're not uncivilized. Your arguments are uncivilized.
That is not true. Like, people are like, why go to a restaurant? It's wasteful. If I went to a restaurant and they served me on a paper plate and threw it in the trash, I'd be like, I'm never going back to this place. That is wasteful. Really?
Fucking street food. They give you
map. I do accept.
Oh yeah.
The map.
I need a new invite, by the way.
Use paper plates or waste 5 months of your life doing dishes. Are you? You know, part of being an adult is like sometimes doing things you don't necessarily want to do for the good of the human race.
Eliminate as many of those as possible by spending a little bit of extra money or being a little wasteful. I'm gonna do it.
Yeah.
That's why I don't fold my clothes.
This is
yeah.
You don't fold your clothes?
No, it's a waste of time.
What
I
are
also
you?
Don't fold my clothes.
This I totally relate to this because when I was younger, I was like, old people are so inefficient. They're always doing things like, you know, they're eating 3 meals a day, paying their taxes, folding their clothes. That's minutes a week I could be saving.
I hate how old you think you are, man.
I'm just I'm responsible.
Yep. No, you've moved into the khaki phase of your elderly.
Yeah, I love chinos, dude. I got no problem wearing some chinos.
I wear chinos.
28.
That doesn't. Being 28 is great when you're like, check it out. I can eat whatever I want and not die. Being 28 sucks when you're like, I eat off of things that I throw in the trash because I'm lazy.
I don't fold my clothes. Okay, let's put this into perspective. I'm a 25-year-old man who doesn't leave his house and plays video games for the entertainment of the internet.
Yo, dress for the
no,
job
I don't
you want,
fold
dude.
My clothes. Well, that's the job I want. It's this job.
You gotta be
headed.
Oh, he's embracing it.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta fold your laundry, man.
Why?
Because you like.
That's like doing your bed. What's the point of doing
your bed? Okay, making your bed is nonsense because literally it's only made when you're not using it, which like making your bed makes no sense. Nick, come on, dude. Who are you trying to impress?
I just like having a made bed. It just feels better that way.
You know, I wanted to roast Ryan, but I'm actually on his side with folding your clothes and making your bed and shit. Because that's not like even an issue of doing it because you're supposed to. It's like it improves the quality of your life.
Your
when
shit's
you have...
gonna be so wrinkly.
Yeah,
he said
but
don't
Ryan's
make the bed and do fold your clothes.
He's against you on the folding.
Oh, you're against making the bed?
Yeah.
Folding your bed makes no sense.
I don't understand it.
Making the bed, no, that's
no, no,
that's
because you're not presenting
you...
Nick for Nick to make his bed makes sense because he's presenting his bed to other people. On his webcam. For me
to look at my stupid bed.
I mean, that's
the way you said that is so weird. Nick is presenting his bed to other people.
Well, that's the reason,
webcam.
Like, I fold my laundry is because, you know, when I go outside, people expect, like, you to be wearing clothes that don't look like a freaking piece of popcorn or something like that.
People expect
I'm presenting my bed.
Why don't you go outside with, you know, why don't we just go outside with dirty clothes then?
Well, sometimes I do.
Okay,
frankly,
see, this is
we're
where...
We're drawing a line somewhere, and apparently
why don't you just
folding.
Shit yourself in public? Who cares?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, look, I don't. Okay. I was on Round Table with a webcam.
Oh yeah, I know that show.
Yeah, right. I was on that recently with, you know, with my.
And there were no comments at all.
Okay.
About my
wall looking like Mosul. But did anybody say, man, Rob's shirt really looks very wrinkly? I don't think anybody did.
Well, you gotta distract him with a dirty wall before they give you credit?
See through your charade.
Yeah, no one cares how wrinkly your shirt is when your wall is a fucking Yemeni prison.
I used the same argument to my chat, or to Kate, because Kate was getting mad at me for not folding the clothes in my chat today. And I was like, no one...
Wait, how often did this come up?
It's been a hot button issue today.
Yeah. But I said, out of the 4 years I've been streaming with a webcam, no one's ever said, hey, nice wrinkly clothes, you dumbass.
Exactly.
Hey, trust me, I've been watching for it.
I wear t-shirts. You don't notice it if it's wrinkly from not
So
being
what do you
folded.
Do? I need to know.
No,
this is important. What happens to the clothes? They come out of the dryer. Where do they go next? Yeah. Take me on a walk through the laundry
Straight
cycle.
On the floor.
They are in a bag or my drawers.
A bag?
Well, it's sometimes.
To be fair, Rob only wears black t-shirts.
Exactly.
Yo, but what is this bag?
It's a laundry bag.
Mesh bag.
It's a laundry
So you put
bag.
It out of the laundry bag into a mesh, or you take it out of the dryer into a mesh laundry bag.
Yeah.
And then you just grab stuff from the laundry stack to wear?
When I need it, yeah.
And then what happens after you take it off?
Then I put it in the garbage pile and I burn it.
You're using a laundry bag exclusively to hold clean clothes?
Well, like I said, not all the time. Sometimes I put it in the drawers as well.
When you get, like, dirty clothes, do you put them in the laundry bag as well?
No. Well,
do you have a separate dirty laundry bag that you use?
Look, this
for...
is America. A man can have more than one laundry bag.
That was an interesting sound.
I'm with you on folding clothes. I think you should fold them, but not because I think it's a good idea, just because it's like a stupid tradition that I've been doing. In some places, though, they'll shame you if you don't iron your clothes, and I think that's going too far.
That's, yeah, you don't need to iron your clothes.
There are times that you iron, but not all the time.
Yeah. Why not iron if you're gonna fold?
Because folding takes care of that shit for you most
of
the time.
Yeah, like, I'm not gonna iron a t-shirt. That's just ridiculous.
Fold a t-shirt. What happened, Kate? Who's gonna notice if you don't?
How do you guys store your underwear? I like to roll mine up.
I'm a folder.
Nice.
I'm a folder.
See, now, the folding of the underwear only makes sense for a couple of reasons. One of which is that they take up less space in the drawer. And the other one is that they just feel nicer when they're like...
now you're
when they're flat and they're not wrinkly, the underwear feels better.
You are insane.
I don't know what the fuck
happened. Wait.
More surface areas making contact with your...
It stretches over your dick. It doesn't like...
Roll it up. You fold it and then
you roll. A roll is fine. I've got no problem with the roll.
This is an important question. Are you a boxer briefs or boxers man?
I'm a boxer briefs man.
So then it doesn't make a difference if you fold them or not then.
How so?
It's elastic and fabric.
Well, are you laying
them
flat? Are you laying them flat in the drawer? Or are you just crumpling them up and then throwing them in?
Are you crumping and tossing?
I need to know, like, here's... When I have to select clothes for the day, I go to my chest of drawers. I open the underwear drawer, I pull out some clean underwear and socks. Go to the t-shirt drawer, pull out a t-shirt, go to the closet, get like something off a coat hanger, right? Are you actually just feeling in the mystery bag until you get a selection of four items that are clean? Like, you're like, oh, I pulled out four pieces of underwear in a row. Like, I've got to keep going until I get a t-shirt.
Well, you know where they are once you touch them once.
Yeah. If I'm particularly lazy, yes. If not, then no, I'll put them in a specific drawer.
I can't help but notice that Austin's being mighty quiet through this last little...
He probably uses a laundry bag, too.
I just got a gift today, or a couple days ago. My mother bought me something for my birthday. She bought me a dresser to send a message.
That's nice. Is that your first?
Yeah.
Dude, make sure you read the instruction manual. It's pretty complicated.
And I literally have laundry that I'm gonna go get after the show and put it into the dresser.
Wow, this is a highly relevant day for you to have this
conversation. Yeah, it is. Very important.
Maybe next year she'll get you a sink and you can finally start doing some dishes.
Actually, secondary. Do you guys
that was
have
a dad have, roast?
You guys have dishwashers in your house?
I do. I do,
but I don't use
okay,
them.
Okay, see that.
I do not.
It's not cheating. Okay. It's just. Oh, so not doing it is the thinking man's way. Doing it efficiently,
exactly.
That's cheating.
No, I would love to have a dishwasher, but I don't
okay.
have one.
Oh,
okay. What do you, got
while
to
you're
say
on a computer,
Kate?
Man? Oh, yeah, hey, let's just abandon technology.
Yo, if my computer could wash my dishes, okay. Then I would let my computer wash my dishes.
I doubt it.
Austin, Kate says that you said your underwear is too small to fold.
Awesome.
You just rocking G-strings all day? Is that what's happening?
Awesome. Tell me about your underwear.
What you have a small waist? You're not buying like size 26 underwear. There's small, medium, large.
He's got a good point.
Look. Look, we don't need to get into this, alright?
I feel like we do. I feel like it's important.
I also feel that, to be honest with you. Look, also bees.
What do you want? What do you want? What do you want me to say? What do you want me to say?
It's explain.
Explain what?
Are you rocking? Okay, so we were talking about
there's
boxers.
So many questions here.
We were talking about boxer briefs. Are you just rocking briefs?
No. But even before that, can we ask what too small to fold even means?
It's like you can only fold a piece of paper 6 times before
right.
it collapses.
Before, yeah. Before you divide by 0, pretty much.
Look, it's too small that you can fold it. You can totally fold it, but the space that you're saving is not proportionate to the time you're spending folding
no.
it.
No. Do you know how long it takes to fold a piece of... Underwear is like top on the folding priority because it's
possibly
so easy.
The easiest, if not
yeah,
socks, maybe.
Why do it if it doesn't?
No, socks take me a little bit longer because I put like one sock in the other.
Oh,
sock.
I mean, me too. But the,
socks
the
are
main
the same
problem,
thing.
No time at all.
No, main problem with socks is you gotta match them. That's
nope.
Oh no,
I
do that problem.
Not
I bought a 20 pack
one
of
standard
black
sock. And then
oh, then
you...
okay, yeah. I mean, I'm,
yeah,
I've probably
yeah.
got like. You know, 15 pairs of 4 different kinds of socks. So, I mean, there is some mixing and matching going on there, I suppose.
Dump all but one
my
and buy another package
a while.
Oh, I got a super pickup. It was 6 snowballs.
That's really good.
Are you saying that you don't match your... You just wear 2 socks of any kind?
Of course!
But why?
You have,
wait,
I
what?
Only have one
what
kind of sock.
Surprise you, though?
I mean, I got. I mean, I'm not gonna wear a white sock and a black sock, but I have.
Why not, Robert?
And I have black socks. Well, because I don't know, it'd look silly if somebody saw my pant leg, but like, they're not generally. Most of the time, how often are your people gonna look up your pant leg?
All the time.
Are they?
The problem with wearing 2 kinds of socks.
if they're thematic, I'll rock 2 different types of socks.
There is, you know what? There's such a chartable NLSS conversation for every single theme. It's always I come over the top being like an extremist, and everybody's like, "Whoa, slow down there, you know, fascist." And then slowly, as the other side elaborates more and more, they go like, "Ah, I was with you until you took it to the level of absurdity, and I'm starting to think that other guy's got a little bit of a point."
It's like you fast forward 5 minutes from, "Why don't we put the socks inside each other too? Why don't we just eat the socks?" That's a good idea.
I would not eat edible socks.
I need to know more.
Yeah. Okay.
You go outside. Let's say it's the spring. You wear sneakers? Okay. Are you a sneaker man?
Sometimes. I really wear boots more.
Okay,
than
sure. Do you put socks on when before you go outside?
Yes, of course.
Map.
Always?
Yes.
Map.
Yeah, okay. No, cuz if you don't wear socks with your shoes.
Map.
I changed the map. It takes a second.
Yeah, but it's more fun to just say map a lot.
Yeah, that's
I like saying map. That's probably my favorite part.
Map.
But anyway, So yeah, of course, because then you're gonna make your sneakers or your boots all stinky if you don't wear socks in your shoes.
Your shoes? Wait, your feet are making your shoes stinkier than your shoes are making your feet?
Yeah.
No, dude.
Well, I don't know what the order of operations is on your feet stink, but I do know that if you're wearing no socks in your sneakers, your boots are gonna get more stinky.
That's probably true.
Did you guys walk around barefoot when you were a kid?
I don't like being barefoot.
Yes,
I know.
Yes, absolutely.
Nah. I did it all the time.
But I didn't live in the city like Robert.
Wait, here's one for you. You're at home. What do you got on your feet?
Nothing.
I have socks. Right
socks
now.
And slippers.
Not
right
a
now.
Damn thing.
But I came home from working, and so like.
Yeah, I was wearing my slippers too.
Okay, let's say it's a Saturday.
Yeah.
Ideal footwear.
Socks
like
and slippers.
Like wake up.
Well, like
not
throughout the
thing.
Day.
Well, like, okay, so, like, check this out. If I wake up and, like, even if, like, I shower, if I'm going somewhere, I'll put on socks before I go somewhere.
Right.
But before I go somewhere, it's bare.
I'm not asking you if you wear socks outside. I know you're not Robert.
No, I don't wear socks.
I wear socks outside!
I prefer no socks to socks.
Really? As long as none of us are, like, I know Nick said slippers. I'm no problem with that. As long as nobody said, like, I'm a shoes in my own house sort of guy.
I can be. Like, I grew up and I always, like, had shoes on.
Inside of the house.
It's not like I fucking woke up and I was like, all right, I gotta put my shoes on and hang out inside. No, like, after you come in from
are you so obsessed with, like, the order of how these things take place? I ask you a simple question and you're like, well,
because there's, like, a spectrum.
So the idea is if you were wearing shoes outside, when you came home, you wouldn't take
you would
them
wear,
off.
Yeah, you would keep the shoes on. Whereas, if you just leave, or if you just like wake up for the day, and you want, I'm not gonna put shoes on and hang out inside. You
but
know?
You would leave them on if you,
yes.
if you came home with them on.
Yes.
Why would
typically.
You?
Yeah.
Not
weird.
So much anymore because, like, I have a home and like I want to keep like the.
Do you have specifically indoor shoes, or would be the same
no,
shoes?
No, I have no indoor shoes.
So, well, you're just making your floor dirty.
Well, I take them, like, now that I am an adult.
Well,
I
didn't mean to offend you. I'm just saying.
No, listen. Now that I'm an adult and I own my own home, I do not wear shoes inside.
All right, that's good.
But you could if
younger,
you wanted
yeah,
to. It's your fucking house.
On, it's my parents' house. Fuck that.
They, yo, but they liked you walking around with your shoes on?
They didn't mind.
That's weird.
You know what? Jess does and tells me it is more common in the UK, so take
oh, here
whatever.
We go.
Yeah, okay. I know. I don't know. Jess is gonna fucking gonna freak the fuck out. But anyway, what she does anyway is wear a dressing gown.
Yeah,
so,
what is
yeah,
that?
I'm
not for that.
Like a.
It's not like a salad basically. Thing.
No. You don't. You, she's not wearing balsamic and oil.
Well, what is she? What is
what's
the dressing
wearing,
gown?
Like a robe. A robe.
A robe?
Yeah.
Okay.
You ever just only wear shoes and nothing else?
There is like a weird... There's a weird equilibrium, or not even equilibrium, but like a point that you cross where you don't feel comfortable in the outfit that you've chosen. Like, you ever put like your socks on before your underwear?
No.
That doesn't feel right, because my ankles are like, I'm good to go. But my cock is like, hey, dude, like, aren't you forgetting something?
That would be real. I would want to.
Then you rub one out, right?
My cock is like, are you forgetting something?
Like, actually, try it next time you get dressed. Well, I don't know about you guys. If I'm completely naked, what clothing are you putting on first? I'm putting on underwear first.
I'm putting on underwear, yeah.
No, yeah. Sure, yeah.
Well, sometimes a shirt. It depends.
T-shirt before underwear?
T-shirt,
if
socks.
T-shirt and then socks?
Okay, this is out of
that's,
the fucking
that's like that's a POW weird, yeah. outfit.
If I'm coming out of the shower, I'm putting on both a shirt
what
and
happened
underwear.
To this level?
So sometimes it'll be a shirt first, but I'm going to put the underwear on like seconds later. So it's not like I'm walking
Ah, fuck you, you big rock.
I might like, I do t-shirt, socks, and like brush my teeth.
What?
Deodorant.
You brush
wait, really?
Your teeth
and
with
then
a t-shirt.
Like underwear at that point, I guess.
You're fucking with me. This is not. That's a sign of mental illness. That's
an illness.
That is an illness.
The order I put my clothes on is an illness.
Well, the fact that you put a chore in between finishing the dressing is indicative of there being a larger problem somewhere.
Nick, are you okay?
No.
Triple roll!
Okay, secondary question, because we all knew it was leading to this. We're all men here.
Yeah, hell yeah. Don't you forget it, buddy.
You have right. sex.
Sorry, what'd you say?
When you're having sexual relations.
What's that?
You take your socks off, right?
Yes. That's what sexual relations is, taking your socks off.
Taking your socks off.
How
do you know it's time for sex unless I'm wearing my business socks?
That's a good point, yeah.
Wait, how do you know it's time for sex?
When I'm wearing my business socks.
Oh.
That's when you know it's business time.
It's business time. Yeah, it's business time.
I know what you're trying to say. You're trying to say it's time for business. It's business time. Ooh.
It's business time by the Flight of the Conchords.
Basically, that was a PSA from me to you, chat. If you're a dude, you take your goddamn socks off when you're having sex.
What if you put on a second pair?
These are my sex socks.
You should definitely put a cock sock on, I'll tell you that much. Just don't make it crusty.
No lovin', no glovin'. Wait, the other way around.
Yeah, hell yeah, dude.
Rob wears boots during sex, probably.
Do you guys take your underwear off during sex?
Never.
No. You pull it through the hole.
Yeah, you just put your dick out through the flap.
Through the hole. That's what it's for.
Leave your balls inside so they don't get hurt.
Why else do they have that there if that's not what it's for? That's what it's for.
Exactly.
Map.
I fucked up my game.
The worst combination of sex clothing. It's like a hat and sunglasses.
Trench
no shirt.
Coat.
A coat, sure. A couple of wristbands.
The vest Aladdin wears before he becomes part of the royalty.
One dress shoe.
And then he's got his dick out through his pants.
Yeah.
And his underwear.
Do you use the flap when you pee? No, I don't use the flap when I pee.
Absolutely not, yeah.
The cloaca.
The flap makes no sense to me.
It's... People use it.
Josh, do you use it?
What?
The flap on your underwear?
The underwear flap. The dick flap.
No, like, when you're wearing, like, boxer briefs, like, that thing is useless.
I don't understand the point.
I can imagine, like, if you were wearing, like, boxers and, like, you did the flap, I'd be like, all right, it's there. Fuck it.
Why is it useless?
Why is it useful?
To put your dick through it.
It's way more work to guide your dick through the labyrinth of the two folds of the flap than it is to just pull the waistband down.
No, that shit, you guys are on crack if you're using the flap on boxer briefs.
I'm not gonna stand for y'all demonizing the flap on boxers.
I have to imagine the flap only exists
boxers,
because
briefs.
Yeah.
Okay, boxers get a pass though.
Yeah, but of course boxers.
That's where we're drawing the line.
I'm not saying boxers get it. Yeah.
Because the boxers.
What? The waistband is so much heavier.
Yeah.
Boxers are like way looser than boxer briefs.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I approved the flap on the box. It's way looser. Why would that? You don't have to feel like you're jimming your cock through the hole.
But like, makes a hole where it wants.
I don't see the argument for the use of the flap. There's no world in which that is the most efficient way.
You gotta save time, man.
That is not saving time. You gotta make two turns instead of taking a shortcut straight through Waistband Alley.
It's like a fucking Harry Potter place.
It's like so you don't have to get your butt out when you're in a freaking...
What? No, Nick.
What?
You're not the dude who pulls down his pants like all the way to his ankles at the urinal, are you?
I was just saying the opposite. I'm saying the point of the flap is so you don't have to down your pants.
You just pull the waistband down over the genitals.
Like a normal, like, Justin civilized man. And do it the old-fashioned way.
You could just not pull your pants down at all.
I'm tired.
Well, you're
going to
open the fly?
Well, yeah, just
you're going to open just the fly and then navigate the flap and the canals of the zipper.
I think we've had a misunderstanding.
I don't know that we have.
I went this.
People are like, does NL not wear a belt?
NLSS story.
You know how many times I've urinated in my life?
Two,
belt off, two. Belt off, button undone, waistband pulled down. Takes like less than a half of 1 second to do.
Absolutely.
Until you do it at the airport, and then it takes like 2 hours.
What are you talking about?
What's yeah, that wait, mean? Why would the airport may take more time?
What is a more complicated bathroom setup there?
When they tell you. When...
Well, you gotta take the time to rate it afterwards.
I'm very like concerned about what I'm hearing here. Yeah, not belt off, belt on buckle. That's all I mean. Hey, what do you guys do? You do the button, or do you do just the zipper when you urinate?
The button, of course, the button.
I've never just, agreed wait, what the more fuck? With Robert in my
what
life.
What the hell does that mean?
Yeah, you just do the like. How are you gonna?
Some people just lower the zipper and then they pull their dangus out. Yeah.
Oh, I've done that. Yeah.
But do you do it?
No, I do not.
Okay. That's
again, I wear boxer briefs now, so I can't.
What if you don't have a button and it's just a flap?
What?
Is that possible? Wait, what do you mean?
First place for one. How? But also, what do you mean you don't have a button on your jeans?
No, that's not what I mean. I meant on the underwear. I thought you were talking about the
underwear. No. I'm talking about jeans. You go zipper or button and zipper.
Oh. Who the fuck does button?
So, like, if...
Who does button?
What? Are you telling me that there's people out there that keep their button on their jeans, pull down their underwear, shove their cock through the zipper hole?
I think if you do zipper only, you have to go flap.
Yeah,
what are
I mean,
these fuckers
the
talking
way.
About?
What the fuck?
You undo your zipper.
I want to hear Josh describe it again.
It's not that difficult.
Wait, Nick.
Jesus
walk
Christ.
Walk us through the urinal.
I just did.
Do it again, please.
Undo your zipper. Pull your dick out of your underwear flap.
Wow.
The end.
Wow. I didn't know that people like you actually exist.
This guy.
No, I'm on team Nick. I'm standing strong with him.
Why not undo the button?
Why not take the button?
There's no problem with it, man.
But you're going to get your dick caught in the zipper.
No, you got to be a fucking idiot to do that.
Matt, it's true.
And you
gotta be a fucking idiot.
It's so much more work. To that's get it true. Through the single aperture, like the lined up eclipse of all the planets, than it is to just undo the flap and then pull it out.
You gotta take a step back comparing your dick to astronomy.
What?
You know what makes it easy, guys? Is that I just got a tiny little wiener down there, so I can pull it out no problem.
Why would you ever have underwear? That just means you gotta do laundry. I just piss in my pants and then throw them out.
Everybody might as well just get diapers.
Yeah, Austin, how do you feel about that diapers. Shit right there?
I'm so tilted.
Why don't you just shit happened? Yourself, Austin, so you never have to do laundry?
Just
spend a little bit more money on diapers that you can just throw out.
I wasn't talking because you were like, how did I get first? Because halfway through that fucking race, my car glitched into the ground and sat there for 30 seconds. Like, move.
Why don't you just shit yourself?
Should've. Jesus.
Oh, fucking triple roll.
I hate it telling me great jump like I did something.
Yeah, like I didn't.
You forced me off the ramp
for jump. I literally was on the goddamn front of the water.
Why am I being attacked in fucking ninth place, though?
Because I was behind you in 10?
Isn't that enough? Isn't that enough?
The flap.
Yeah, the whole flap thing. You honestly have to stop that.
Hashtag team flap, where are you at in chat? Let me see you, stand strong.
They're just going to spam it because they want to. You can't say that.
Hell yeah, dude. That means we win if that happens.
Oh, there were so many coins there.
But I'm not gonna let you shame everybody that does that is the main thing.
When you pull it through the flap, you're like dislodging your penis and you gotta like
oh my god,
you're not dislodging your penis.
You're dislodging your penis. You're pulling it up and out.
Yeah, he has a point. Let me tell you what you're doing with your dick.
It snakes out of you. You don't wanna do that.
Absolutely
it's so much more work.
I'll never understand it, honestly.
Oh, the fucking...
Hey!
I just like... Is what? It that much more work to unbutton the flap?
I can't I see chat. I argue that it's less work, flap, honestly.
I think it is as well, yeah.
Or at least, you know, it's more steps, but the steps save you time in the end.
That's probably true.
And at this point, when you pull it back in, how does that work?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. What, are you going to just keep it up in your belt?
You know what I think happened? Okay, at some point in my life, I was like, yeah, you know, this hole is probably here for a reason.
Okay,
I guess I could do this. Oh, all right. And then I just kept doing it that way.
Yeah.
And I never made, like, a conscious decision at any point that this was, like, the superior method. I was just decided that this was how I was going to do
just
it.
Just following orders. I get it.
Yeah. My point is, you should have made that. You should have taken the critical thinking.
You know what? The less decisions that I'm aware of having made, the better.
You know, the best time to learn how to pee was 20 years ago. The second best time is today.
Yeah.
Man, I had to learn how to write differently because I hold my fucking pencil like a weirdo.
Why don't you just say
I do that too.
Not like a weirdo.
Yeah, you hold your fucking pants pencil like a weirdo too.
That's how you know. That was good.
It's not that hard to do the flap.
Yeah, but like, how do you put your dick back in? Like, how does it slide in?
How do you put your dick? I want to know this too.
How do you think I put my
isn't
dick back
your
in?
Schlong touching metal at times? Like,
I have a pulley
and
lever
system. Yeah,
and
I'm a man. I can handle a metal bit on my dick.
Yeah, but why would you?
Yeah,
you
but we
to.
Can't handle your metal bit on your dick.
I just don't understand why you would willingly want that. It's like, yeah, I can handle like a broken leg as well, but I'm not gonna actively
iron.
Seek it out like four times
I'm
a day.
I'm not afraid of some little copper fucking stupid fly. It's made of iron.
I get off on the minor pain every time I take a piss.
Yeah. I
honestly,
cut it in the zipper just to see which one's tougher.
I really am more concerned about the other part is how you reassess your penis situation afterwards. Like, what do you do with your dick? You, like, massage it?
What do you do with it afterwards?
Wait, yeah, what are you talking about reassess?
Well, okay, so think about the physics of this, right?
Okay.
You whip out your dick, right, and you're going to be putting it back through the little flappy thing,
well, I'm
right?
a super paralooper, guys.
Me too.
Whatever the fuck that means.
So when you're pulling it back into the flap, or pushing it back into the flap, because pulling it out, it's going to be sitting in the proper location,
yeah.
right?
The sun may rise in the east.
Exactly. When you put it back in, how is it going to reassert its dominance in the downward fashion that is the most comfortable?
You just mash it.
See? Exactly! That's the part that I wanted to hear, because that sounds awful. Why would you do
smash
that?
It in there!
Smash it up, just slam it into the edge of the urinal. Just pound it.
Show it who's dominant.
I don't understand.
Lady Grey, you're lucky you don't hear this bullshit.
Just smash it.
Good kid.
You guys need to go to like a workshop or something.
Or church.
They say if you're scared, go to church.
Sticker is unlocked. Oh, hell yeah. Super paralooper, dude. Sticker awarded.
I got an award for getting hit by other things 10 times. Great.
Map.
What else do you guys do with your dicks?
Map.
I make maps.
Really? That's amazing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm the world's first dick cartographer.
Ooh.
Pretty cool.
So, like, tell me about that.
I'm not going to give you a straw poll. Do your own straw poll.
You have to do it so it's officially sanctioned.
I don't give a
shit. I'm kind of curious about this, too. I want to know where chat falls on this.
The first one I see is official, as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. Oh, they can't link it because there's no links. That's right. Well,
wrecked.
You know, if a mod does it, that's official as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah. How do you feel about button flies? I don't like them.
What's not a button fly? Oh,
well,
the one. Yeah,
it's all buttons.
Yeah. Right.
It's all
yeah.
I like them.
Yeah. I'm a zipper man personally, but I have both.
Yeah. I have both too, but like the thing is, like, you know, it's just more work. You know, you gotta button all up. You gotta button up all
well,
the buttons.
You were expressing a certain intimate fear about being crushed inside of the zipper. Now, if you bring a button problem in, there's not much you can do other than strangulate it to death.
Yeah, get,
I mean,
like, snaps.
Like, that's true. Like, that, I have less fear with a button fly, yet...
You could loop a fucking pube around the inside of the button and rip it off.
Well,
not my buttons! Not my gumdrop buttons!
Shrek.
Yeah.
Oh, no!
Oh, I almost had a pool shot. Oh, I did have a pool shot!
I don't really wear pants anymore, though.
What is wrong with you? You guys are actually in for, like, a rude awakening.
No, I wear gym shorts all the time.
All nice. The time?
Oh, yeah.
And you think I'm old?
Good luck with this one, Bear.
It's like a 70-year-old's outfit.
Old on the other side. What?
How is that elderly?
Wearing exclusively gym shorts
is a very youthful
I mean, I it's
endeavor.
Almost like something that gets you put on the register. You gotta keep that shit tied up as much as possible.
Well, okay. Though, I'm kind of with Bear on this one, but the thing that I want to ask is, if you're going out to dinner, you're not wearing your gym shorts.
Yeah,
you
going
out?
Put on jeans.
You put on jeans.
Then, yeah, put
right?
on jeans.
I hope
yeah.
so.
Yeah. If I'm going to the store, I'm with Bear. I wear my pajamas.
Yeah, no, fuck the store, man. Fuck the people in the store thinking I need to wear jeans. No.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm going to wear my comfy-ass shorts and pants in the store.
I only have to impress one person aesthetically, and she's not there to watch me go to the store and buy beers. So, like... I'm fine on that front.
This is what the other fucking.
I know, dude.
Of the tracks is like.
Do you see, like, you're over there in the private sector. I've got to fight against these influences day in and day out.
Like, who gives a shit about people in the supermarket? Like, who cares?
You're telling me gym shorts at Walmart is what's wrong with society?
I'm saying that's, like, maybe a part of it.
No!
Gym shorts, fucking pulling your dick out through holes.
Oh, Jesus. You should try, like, going out in the kind of, like, outfit that makes people respect you and, like, not look, give you a funny look when they see you.
Yeah. Like, when's, like, take your... When's take your YouTubers to work day? Because everyone's... I don't know if I would take you guys. I would have to take
Ryan. How is that position anything but superficial?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You guys are... Don't try to swerve your laziness into, like, an enlightenment. Come on, now.
No,
if you don't have respect for yourself, have respect for me, at least.
But you're never gonna see these people ever again. Who cares?
I might see them again. Who knows, dude?
So
who knows? Maybe you're in the store and, oh, look at that. That's Bill Gates. Oh, excuse me, Bill Gates, can I have $1 billion? No, you're wearing gym shorts. There you go. You just cost yourself $1 billion.
Bill Gates is a bad example because Bill Gates, like, wears the same sweater and...
If you're a
like,
billionaire, you can wear whatever the fuck you want.
It's wow. True. It all comes out.
Yep. Yep. It classist all right here.
No wonder out. He's so pro-corporation on Roundtable.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
It all comes out.
You walked right into that one, buddy.
No, I drove into it with my Porsche 911 GTR that Bill Gates gave me because I showed
goddamn
up wearing an
1%.
Adult outfit to the supermarket that he also frequents for some reason.
All right, what positive benefit have you gained previously from getting dressed up to go to the supermarket?
I don't know. I feel good about myself because I'm well-adjusted to adult life.
Well, so then that's a personal accomplishment for yourself. That doesn't make me feel better. It makes me feel like I wasted my time.
What? Like putting on clothes?
Yeah, but put on jeans and getting all dolled up to go to the supermarket.
dolled up!
Fucking jeans. You know what I was like? When I go out, I'm just like, I'm not going to really work at this. You know, I'm just fucking going. I go out in jeans. That's like my bottom line.
Should I file my nails? Cut my split ends.
I mean, you can file them down. You don't want them like weird.
I'm all like pointy, like you know, Smeagol or something
like
that.
Fucking daggers
I mean,
on your hands.
Yes, I do cut my nails, but that's
just leave the pinky.
Should I brush my teeth?
Well, again, that's for me though.
No, that's for the people around you.
Why not just go naked? Because it's illegal.
Here's my impression of the NLSS.
That's the number one rule.
Here's the thing. Oh, logical extreme.
Yeah.
Yeah,
what if we were all blind? Would you still put on jeans then?
Position presented as ultimatum.
Yeah.
Why is that Yoda?
That was not Yoda.
That's pretty close to Yoda. It's almost
not Yoda.
When 900 years you reach, looks so good. You are not.
Hey Yoda.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Yeah. That's Yoda if he was a German.
All right. I want to revisit this conversation in like
5 years.
Yeah, and just see what it's like.
This conversation 5 years ago.
I wish. Yeah, me too. Actually. I'm like, hell yeah, dude, who has time for that shit, folding their laundry? I'm doing valuable stuff like watching an entire season of a television show in one day. I couldn't possibly afford to be distracted with something like folding my laundry while I do it.
That makes me feel much more complete than getting, you know, dressed in jeans and folding my laundry.
Watching an entire television series?
Yes. Absolutely.
I know, Josh. Like, this is where you have these conversations and you go, maybe they're right about millennials.
Yeah, like I've heard bits and pieces about like this whole like Skype conversation that I'm not in. I'm really glad that I'm not.
You're in it.
Oh no, you are. I don't look at it. I block that shit.
Hello, Josh.
To keep sane from this.
Wait, you could leave it. You don't have to block it.
No, I'm just fucking with you guys.
Oh.
You know what? Your war on happiness has got to stop.
Yeah, seriously.
And I'm going to front the resistance.
Look, somebody's got to pretend to be aristocratic. Otherwise, there's no dynamic in this conversation.
Are you just trying to save face for all the actual responsible adults out there who are looking for that positive influence?
I feel like we have an impressionable audience. And then, like, I worry that they're going to be like, well, you know, Robert lives an out of control lifestyle, so it's okay.
Yeah, but like, am I the person on the NLSS that people look up to and be like, you know what? I want to be more like Rob.
I don't know if you can control.
I want to be more like Rob.
Nick, your car is awesome, by the way.
I don't want us to be the gross crew, guys.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but I don't want him to be the adult just because he thinks that the other adults want him to be the adult.
Man, I mean, I am the adult. I might live one of the. Josh probably lives a more adult life than I do. Despite having more childlike wonder, I would definitely say that that's probable.
I have a mortgage.
Josh has, like, Josh has the most adult life.
I think that's fair. But of the people doing this full time, I might have the most adult life, for better or for worse.
I don't know. I think Bear has a.
No, yeah, don't put me above.
I see this motherfucker playing Rocket League at like 2 p.m. every Tuesday. So don't tell me it's like that's a normal adult situation.
I got a schedule, man. Let me live my schedule, but I'm not gonna put myself on the pedestal.
In the morning is,
That's my different. 45 minutes of leisure time a night, so I don't go postal.
Who takes it at different times? I'm the one that's not.
I'm not trying to sell you out.
Schedule.
I'm trying to sell Robert out because he tried to.
You sold Rob out by selling Bear.
I saved your face, and then you threw me under the bus. That's exactly what happened. Exactly. I was looking out for you.
I have no horse in this race. I know I don't lead the most adult life out of anybody. Well, yeah, I mean, like probably anybody.
But you own a. Oh, you said you don't own a horse.
Yeah, no, I don't.
Oh,
have
that's
no
true.
Horse.
Dan also hilariously probably leads one of the most adult lives.
Yeah,
Dan is more adult than I am.
That's probably true. Yeah. I mean, he has a kid.
He does. Yeah. True. And he probably has a mortgage too.
He might have more than one.
He has probably like 10.
Yeah.
Having the kid is like, I think that's just that supersedes everything, honestly.
Like, is like when you have a kid, you multiply your adultness by a factor of either like 10 or negative 10. If you have a kid and you're taking care of it, you are 10 times the adult that an adult without kids is. If you have a kid and you're not taking care of it, you're more of a child than
a kid is. Oh, man. Oh, that's a double-edged sword right there. Children are dangerous.
Yeah, dude. They really could go either way, right?
They could burn the knob on the stove, burn the whole house down. You don't want that.
Could end up raising a bunch of dirty flap users.
When you said it like that, I thought it was a new app for iPhone.
Pretty flap users.
Did we get that straw poll?
Apparently,
yeah,
it's
I
want to
know.
Yeah.
Hey!
I almost care about this more than the fish and chips thing. I want to know.
I love that somebody said they sent us that picture of that enormous piece of fish, and we're like, there's no way you can eat this with your hands. And then you fuckers were like, you just pick it up. You don't pick it. It's too big to be wieldy when you pick it up.
It was literally not even that big. It was the size of like one and a
third of a pizza, of a slice of pizza.
It was also
so small.
They had the French fries there. It was the size of the length.
What
fries.
Have I done?
Shut up! You brought this up. I was irrationally angry when that was tweeted at me. Oh, how can I pick this up? It's so big.
Okay. Apparently, 60% are button and waistband.
60%?
Yeah.
That's much.
Wait, what?
I would have thought it was like 85.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know what straw poll we were doing. I thought we were doing flap users.
Matt. Well, that is flap users.
Matt.
Wait, are you doing button, Matt. Waistband, and then pulling your dick out through the flap?
Matt. Wait, hold on. What?
Wait, yeah, no, this is, that's important.
That's the worst of all worlds.
What I'm doing, I got map, just map, like straight up jeans map, with a zipper.
Map.
Yeah. Boots with the furs. All right.
Okay, jeans with a zipper. Got it.
Apple bottom jeans with the boots with the
furs. Yeah, boots with the furs, yeah.
You got jeans with a zipper. You take the zipper down and you pull it out of the flap. That's it.
Take the zipper down, pull it out. Okay, so yeah. I mean, if you're in for a penny, in for a pound.
Yeah.
If you're already going to do the wrong thing, you might as well do
one. You're only going through.
No, he's got to go through the flap. He's got to go through the flap, and then he goes through the zipper with the button still done up.
Yeah.
Well, so but like the two other flaps. Way around. He goes through
two flaps. Yeah,
the flap and the zipper.
I'm a two-flap Tony.
I want to find the one flapper.
Yeah, the dude who pulls his jeans
the
off.
The waistband and then the...
And then puts it out through the flap anyway. It's like, I want people to see the back of my legs, but I don't want them to see my balls. Okay, here's a question. For those of you who are waistbanders, you pull your balls out too?
No. That'd be awesome.
You don't? You just pull the dick out?
Most of the time.
Wait,
yeah.
I'm trying to think. I'm trying to
pull balls to pee properly.
I'm trying to think.
You would have to. No, you don't need to pull the pulling balls out is excessive.
Yeah, that is. That's totally like
unreal. And hilarious.
I'm trying to think. I'm trying to imagine myself at a urinal. Do I pull the balls out?
Well, you don't know.
I'm trying to think. Like, it doesn't feel like I.
You're fucking sagging nuts. Like,
oh, so I'm the weirdo at the dude looking over at the urinal.
I'm just saying, like.
You think any of our parents are watching this episode?
My parents usually cut out after like the first hour.
Alright. They're just really big fans of Isaac.
It's bad that they've spawned me. I can't imagine if you guys had my parents.
That'd be weird, right?
That would be weird, yeah.
I'd be like, wow, my brother is a jerk.
Yeah.
I do want to know, though, like, what Pop Smith does to his dick.
Pop Smith?
Does it to his dick? He probably does Mom Smith.
He doesn't do her with his dick. He does her to his dick.
To his dick.
What does that even mean?
Come here to my dick.
Why would you go through the effort of pulling the balls out? I'm just trying to think, like, isn't it more effort to keep them in?
It depends on the tightness of the underwear, to be honest.
And the tightness of the balls.
Because you don't want to get a drip 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 from having to
take your money.
Talking about
drip 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 is rip 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 for your underwear.
Pretty much, yeah.
Little April showers.
It's like you pull the nuts out if it's real tight.
Yeah, you pull the nuts out if it's real tight.
Yeah, you pull the nuts out.
You pull the nuts out if it's real tight.
And then you put your balls in her butt.
Yeah. You pull the nuts out of it. It's real tight, though.
Get out of here, you fucking up. Oh, you bitch, piece of shit.
He's so rude.
I am rude. I'm sorry.
Brings out the worst in us.
I'm going to play Outrun inside of this game instead of this.
I really like your car, Nick.
I had to pay for it.
You just got hit by a fucking Pokeball.
Wait, how do you flip, Isaac, baby?
You use right analog stick.
Is that a fact? Does it affect your ability to race?
Yeah, you can become a super paralooper, dude.
What is it? What?
Do 25 stunts in a single match, you become a super paralooper.
As a side note, I just want to say, I find it real funny that the Total War car, when he transforms, it just puts a sigil in front and doesn't show him transforming because they didn't want to do the animation.
Huh.
Oh. Pretty good. Yeah.
Fucking lazy ass Sega.
Yeah, fucking lazy stupid game developers.
Yeah, wish they could be more like fucking characters in this game.
Ubisoft. Make game of the year like For Honor.
I almost want to go back and try it again.
For Honor?
You should.
I don't know, it's pretty old. It has been out for like a week and a half.
Well, I mean, like, by the fucking games we got coming out the next month or so, you'd think so.
Well, yeah, Mass Effect Andromeda, right? Soon.
You got that, you got Horizon that I'm not allowed to be excited about.
I didn't say that. I just want boy, I'll go look at the Metascore. Go look at the Metascore, sheeple.
What is the Metascore on?
It's like 88.
Yeah, it's good.
It's extremely good. Everyone's like, I'm really excited for Horizon Zero Dawn. What's your Metascore prediction? Ow, 7 out of 100.
I said 78.
I think that's a pretty reasonable guess based on, like,
I expected it to be above average, not exceptional.
78, hold on.
It's a bit above that.
So, you're allowed to not be hyped over a game that you think is going to be very good, but no one's allowed to be hyped about a game that they think is going to be
Oh, this sentence, nope.
Do you ever think that hypnotists only can hypnotize people who believe they can't be hypnotized?
It's a hard sentence to say, in fairness.
It's like, it had to be 75% of the length for me to stay on board, and then
let me guys ask you this. What do you guys...
Let me ask you this.
Who's going to play the new Zelda?
Oh, me? Boy.
And what are you playing this new Zelda on?
Channing Tatum.
Yeah, probably.
I'm just gonna stare at the disc until it imagines into my head.
Like, we're all getting like the Wii U because the Switch is dumb, right?
Cancel
the Switch pre-order.
Yeah.
I'm probably gonna get the Switch out of a sense of like journalistic responsibility.
Yeah.
But that's weird. That's
one. Get it for me. I want it for journalism too.
Yeah. I mean, you can write it off on taxes. So.
I use the word journalistic in not exactly
as an
serious tone.
Yeah, when does the Switch ship?
Jim Short air quotes.
When does the Nintendo Switch ship?
You keep asking that. I don't know, man. Yeah.
When is it supposed to be out? Friday.
Friday.
Yeah, should ship on like Thursday then, right?
It's probably shipped a month ago and it's street dated and in everybody's back room.
What, they send it on freaking Kevin Costner as the postman or something?
Yeah.
No, he just delivers it to you directly.
I can understand getting a Switch like when the new Mario King comes out at the end
Mario
of the
year. King?
Mario. Yeah, the new Mario King. When that comes out at the end of the year, I could see getting a Switch then.
All right. Fair enough. I agree.
Man, I did 5 spins and got jack shit.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I got Swarm slow you down less now.
Nice.
Really useful. Hey,
is Kristen home?
Hey, just go to youtube.com/northernlion starting this weekend for Nintendo Switch gameplay. The hottest Nintendo Switch gameplay, 60 FPS, 1080p if the game support it. See you over there. Subscribe to be part of the Lion Pride. I like Zelda. I mean, I don't love Zelda like weird people who like make their whole lives about Zelda.
And enjoy,
like this
happiness.
Well, when I watch it or when I play it, I'm like, oh, this is a good game. But I don't go, oh, this game has like changed my life or something like that. You know.
But what if it does?
Can't happen. I'm insulated.
I'm insulated. Are you fucking electric wire? What does that mean?
I wish, dude. I fucking wish.
Who is fucking my hole?
Oh my god.
We are all in just a giant cluster in the middle right now.
Yeah. Dude, what if it changes your life?
It won't. I'm an adult.
I hate.
How can it change anyone's life? It's a video game.
Exactly correct.
Nick, you are the...
Nick playing Devil's Advocate is exactly correct.
Yeah, Speaking of video game dreams, I want to say something in like 100% seriousness.
Okay.
Playing Elite Dangerous Horizon with the HOTUS. What was that giant fart?
We're talking about the HOTUS again.
I want to say it's like it's everything that I wanted it to be. It's so cool, man.
Bear, you're such a Dan.
Oh, you got him.
Wait, what's the Elite Dangerous?
How in the fuck y'all can't be excited about VR space combat? Like, what's wrong with you?
I'm excited. I want to hear more.
I'm jealous because I don't have a Vive, all right?
No.
Yeah,
I mean,
I'm jealous because I do have a Vive and it doesn't fucking work.
I'm jealous because you use virtual reality to distract you from the coming Luddite versus futurist war that's going to leave hundreds and thousands of people out of work and possibly even dead as well.
You're like very clearly in the Luddite camp, though.
Excuse me?
I was hoping you'd...
What is a Luddite?
I was hoping you'd say that again. That's pretty good.
People that eschew technology.
Yeah. The Amish.
Yeah. People
I've
with
seen them
shoe
before.
Technology.
I think
think that my training is going to pay off in 25 years. And
yeah, definitely NASA's going to be like, we need someone who played a lot of video games to be our next astronaut.
Hey, you know, that happened in the military, didn't it? Like with the,
No, that happened in Armageddon.
Yeah, that happened in the film Armageddon.
Yeah, that's the military, right? I
mean, specifically Dark Souls players lately.
I think you're thinking of an anime.
Oh, yeah. You
let me know when someone needs to explore a space dungeon, all right? I'll
be right. Be great, though, wouldn't it?
Probably, like, not, though.
No, why not? Get Jadong to, like...
Jadong?
Jadong.
Yeah, Jadong. He's famous StarCraft II professional.
He's not that famous. I've never heard of him. Yeah, get Mathis to play him. Is he better than Mathis?
Like JWoww's boyfriend.
The WoW.
Who's JWoww?
Never mind.
Nick, who's JWoww?
Nick, what the hell is a JWoww?
It was from, like, the Snooki era.
Oh yeah, that was she was the Jersey Shore girl, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Fucking mega jet boys.
Look, I'm real tired. I didn't sleep like hardly at all last night. I'm like falling asleep playing this game right now.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel ya.
I stayed up way too late playing Hollow Knight, and then I had to get up for the dentist, and I didn't nap, so now I'm just like dead.
Mm. No, I didn't get hit by that goddamn truck. That's some bullshit.
You're lucky we're towards the end of the show, mister. There's a lot in that sentence to tease apart.
You guys want to tease your hair at PAX?
What?
No, I'm going to be a little busy watching all the fucking Fast and the Furious movies. Exactly.
Just all the Fast and Furious ones.
Josh, go to PAX East.
No.
Yeah, please, though.
No, go to... If I go to PAX East this year, will you guys go to PAX South next year?
No.
Yes.
All right. I will.
All right, well, then I'm not going to do PAX East, and you guys just do PAX South. All
right, wow, cool. You're saying so just because only one of us is going to go that you won't do it? Well, you got a problem with Austin?
Do
then?
You ever think that?
No. I was going to say go to PAX South regardless, and then I wasn't going to East.
All right, why don't we take some time to pimp our channels? We'll start with a little bit of Bear Taffy.
Just a sprinkle of bear.
Sprinkle a bear
in your life.
Rainbow bear.
Hi, everybody. Twitch.tv/BearTaffy, YouTube.com/BearTaffy, and Twitter.com/BearTaffy. I do a lot of things on the internet with these guys. Hey, man, how about that?
Sweet, who's next?
You're the one who usually tells us who's next.
Yeah, Austin.
Hi, I'm Josh. You can find me at BearTaffy.com.
Austin is
when you sigh during my pitch, it discredits the whole thing. It makes people think I'm not a serious online entrepreneur.
Austin is next.
Twitch.tv/last_grand_wolf. Come watch Friday Zelda all day, Friday forever, Rick and Morty.
Be
Zelda.
100 years.
How about how about you, Robert?
Yeah, hello. I am Robert, also known as Rob, also known as Alpaca Patrol everywhere. Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube. YouTube, you got For Honor, you got the Factorio, you got the other things. On Twitter, other things, discord.gg/AlpacaPatrol for my Discord, and also on Twitch. I stream pretty much every goddamn day, so come by and follow. I've been streaming some Hollow Knight. Actually, and I got to a really cool area today that had awesome music and was cool, and I'm gonna keep playing it, so come back and do that. And then I'm gonna play Zelda as well, but probably on Saturday.
I want to raise a criticism about Hollow Knight.
Okay.
It's only got two dimensions.
Actually, apparently it's rendered in 3D so that they can do the parallax. Yeah.
Did they bring enough dimensions for the rest of the class? Because I only see 2D when I play it.
Can you have 7,000 dimensions?
Hollow Knight is bad as fuck.
I gotta think about that one. that's a subscriber, Nick. Don't call out my subscribers for ignorance.
Flood!
Josh, why don't you take some time to pimp your channel?
Hi, the world is a vampire. That's all Angelina Jolie's ass. All
right, sweet. All right. Nick.
Wait, what? The vampire is her ass?
Where is For Honor? Well, Robert, would you like to explain why I have no For Honor on my channel today?
Thanks, Stanley, for that video a day early.
Exactly.
Okay.
All right.
I Nick. Didn't know, though. Come on. How am I supposed to know that?
What a bunch of things.
All right, Nick, why don't you take some time to pimp your channel?
Hey, everybody. You can find me over on Twitter if you want to follow me for updates when I go live. That's the place to go, twitter.com/rocklysmile. I have to sleep now, so I probably won't be playing Hollow Knight tonight. Maybe later. Maybe like at 3 in the morning I'll wake up and then play Hollow Knight, but probably not, to be perfectly honest. But I'll finish it more later. I actually beat it last night, but now I just want to get the
100%. Well, that's a little personal, isn't it?
I just beat off last night. and thank you to everybody that subscribed and followed and tipped today.
Sweet.
Thank you very much.
Don't let those heathens strong arm you. Zipflap is both correct and designed for this purpose.
Oh,
thank
bullshit.
You.
Just because it exists doesn't mean that's what it's there for. Fucking
designed for this purpose.
Yeah.
Just because they give you a fork and knife.
I love you guys. Later.
Just because there's roads doesn't mean you need to buy a fucking car. Okay. I'm hanging up on you. Goodbye. Right, and thank you for being
see
here.
You guys. Thanks.
Oh, geez. Thank God that's over with. Am I right? Hey, Kate. How's it going?
Yeah, while you're calling out the subscriber name, can I play a song?
Sure. It's actually a piece, though.
No, it's not. Well, you know what? If you want the piece, I can be the piece.
No, it's okay. Play some stuff. Give me some background info. What are you going to play on your show, Kate?
I'll play some Isaac and some recorders.
All right. There you go. All right. Here, I'm going to start with the cheers. Here we go. Wolfie owns you. Hare Krishna, Crooked Phoenix, Overlord King, and Happy Hansel. Thank you very much for the cheers. 5x10. Insomniacus, Nomad Wolf, Tattoo 14, Ragsin, Pelvis Pounder 42, The Sasquatch, Taekwondo, Demena, Fish Pasty, Harley 913. Stoke 27, Captain Oblivious, Beauty and the Beast, Plebeian J, Andy S. Quelp, Glitched Universe, Shlomo 122, Maximalist, Malamarky, Topher 216, Lindigo, Khaki 5000, Psycho Mike 12, Seafreak 12, Sine is not a fraud, A Frosty 2 is 203, A tale as old as time. Age is like a wine. Zach Lynch, Laws de Muerte. A sexy ninja. Chili Blast Chicken, or Chill Blast Chicken. Chocoroid, A Pointer, Noctan Knights. Oogoof, Sadeka 7. Count up your sins, unsheathe his katana. Chips 544. All right, what's next, Kate? I still got a lot to go here. Oh, there's more. Wait, Kate, I'm gonna find one for you, okay? This was beautiful, don't get me wrong, but give me a sec here.
Yo, I was playing that,
yo,
man.
I gotta find another piece for it. Oh, here you go, Kate.
Okay.
Yeah, no doubt.
All right. I got it.
Let's go, boys.
Na, da, 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 it's da, hard! Da. I don't remember all the fingering.
You never sight read A Whole New World before?
What's the B flat? I don't know.
I can show you the world.
I forgot the fingering for the B flat.
Netzank Southwest, Mr. Fabulous, Furon Alive, Dunkachino, Barrow's Boy, Teebs 64, there we go, the Ragamuffin Man. My name is Legend X, Dr. Pezzer, the Code Machine, Euphorious. Oh, we hit a little too early. Freely Willy Nilly, Stratosphere 24, Volyodnak, Dr. Torch 007, Las de Merte, Dude Meister 99, Cole Pal, Captain Jobby, Random Clover, Samuel Jams, Cole 500, Nyaka, Mad Snorkel, Chucko the Party Clown, Erdovia, Pet Reaper, Niles Dickish, Destamond, Deep Sea Fanglyfish, TJ Man 112, Warship Satin, Super Pac-Man, Dash, J-Bell, V-Mad Matt, Bag of Derp, Elder Horse, God, 50 Nug or Die, Fishy McFishfish, Zappler, BJ Schnog, Prince Artemis, Ryzik, Varroa, also Graham Cracker, 511 Were, Dirty Dangles, Otarion, Yonquil, Xanthippe, La Belle Vache, Anon 24601, Lemony Fresh, Carbuncle, Valhalla, Shiny, and Chrome. Geo 222, Teagle 423, Import Username, Sojourn Apocalypstic. And thanks for all the support. Kate will be live on Twitch TV. /lovelymomo. So you should go and watch her play some Isaac on her stream.
Well, thank you.
That was beautiful.
Thank you.
I've never freestyle sung before.
thank you.
All right. Okay. Thanks for watching, guys. That was just about the hardest thing I've ever done intellectually in my life, to read all those nonsensical names and numbers while also hearing the most beautiful rendition of A Whole New World in the background. Hey, anyway, thanks for watching. You can go to twitch.tv/lovelymomo and watch Kate play Isaac and the recorder over there. See you. I'm gonna host her. See you then. Thanks for the show. It was a good show.